Yay.
Yay. Hi.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
And on that note, when we last left off, the battle cattle was put together by the cowgirl Reaha, a acolyte of the Bee Girl tribe who found in their tomes of lore reference to an ancient oracle living off in the mountains. From this oracle, she hopes to find the cure, or at least some hint as to the cause of why cowgirls are all born in a strange, mentally locked state. God damn it, Scout. So, with no proper adventurers to help her, and the quest being much too dangerous for a lone pregnant cow, or at least eggnant, she called upon her friends, the cowgirls she had helped awaken, to escort her into the mountains beyond the reach of the hobgoblins, and to find this mysterious oracle. But, along the way, the party ran afoul of hobgoblins several times, including, most recently, an ambush at a hobgoblin camp where they managed to rescue a slave girl hobgoblin who had been captured along with Hazia the ram girl, who you met fleeing from an ogre that the party boned into submission, or at least unconsciousness.
Moo!
Moo, indeed.
Half the party.
All right, half the party, sorry. The other half, however, was obviously just, you know, they were providing moral support. Ready to strike.
I got a splinter in my boob.
Yeah, that hurt a lot. Cows were not made to climb trees, apparently.
No.
Moo.
Indeed. That's like trying to, shave your sack with sandpaper.
No.
What you need are monkey cows.
Oh, God.
Climb up into trees and throw milk at you.
Ook moo.
Ook moo.
Ook I'm in the duker.
God damn it.
Mooka.
God damn it. Fuck that. Fuck. Fuck yeah. Ook Dukum or whatever his name was. Fuck that guy. And fuck that whole part of that expansion pack. Oh, ook you in the duker.
Fucking Pandaria. Monkeys everywhere.
Jesus, did I just turn into DCL for a minute?
Yes.
A little bit.
Mookum in the mooker.
Mook them in the milker.
Mook them in the milker. Mook. Mook. Moo.
So on that note, we rejoin the battle cattle as they have just fished a unconscious hobgoblin out of the river. And you have two other hobgoblins who are passed out face first in the dirt, having just finished DPing Dallas. A half-ogre mercenary is sitting next to the campfire working on some wood carving. She doesn't appear to notice you guys, or at least pay you any mind at the moment. Oh, and there's a hobgoblin who is hog-tied on the ground. Is sort of doing the worm a little bit.
Sure, I'll help her. Hi! No, untie.
Who are you?
Pumpkin. Nice to meet you.
She slowly rises to her feet and looks around. You're all... cowgirls?
Moo!
Moo!
Moo! Except for her!
Moo! Hi!
Hi!
Hi?
Hi.
Yo.
Hi.
She looks around very confused at the extremely warm, jubilant welcome she's getting.
Like, dust her off.
Oh, thank you.
What you doing out here? They're all very mean.
I escaped from the city. She'll point up to the huge towering walls up in the distance.
I see you.
Yeah, the eye of Sauron slowly passes by.
Well, then we stab him in the cornea.
Yes. Oh, fuck my fucking eye. Oh, Jew tenacious.
We do like, what's it called? Dead Space. Go full fucking Dead Space on his ass.
You mean you would just use our plasma cutter and then stomp attack him into little chunks?
No, the Dead Space 2 there. Remember when you're supposed to inject that thingamabob in your eye?
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah.
The eye horror happens to you. It's awful.
It just rams it in and starts just spooning your brain in like a blender.
So what you're saying is we need to fuck the eye of Sauron. Okay.
Got it.
Yeah, it's glory hole.
Throw my load in the glory hole.
God damn it. I thought I got away from that song.
Never. Oh yeah, it's not the eye of Sauron, it's the tit of Mooron.
Moo!
Moo.
Moo!
We're off to see the wizard.
The wizard?
Yep. Wanna come?
Hazia will clop up and sort of glance around nervously. What do you mean, wizard? They're not going to turn us into toads, is he?
No.
But that's what wizards do, isn't it?
I'm pretty sure this one isn't a toad wizard. He's a no-stuff wizard.
Only the really boring ones. The good ones give you bigger tits.
Huh. I don't need those. I'd fall over all the time.
It'd be a good look for you.
No. I'd try to be sneaky. If they're too big, I'd just fall down.
Well, then they'd cushion it so it didn't make noise.
Yeah, that's true. They already do that. Just fucking jiggle them. Bounce, bounce, bounce.
You see Hazia sort of lock her knees together and look pointedly away from you. So he's a good wizard, right?
Yeah!
He's gonna help the other cows.
What's wrong with the other cows?
They aren't smart like us.
So you just hear the ogre girl just start laughing for a minute. Just covers her mouth. Goes back to wood carving.
She'll pout.
So the slave girl will look between the lot of you and say, When you're done with the wizard, are you going to Pergolith, maybe? Or somewhere not here?
Gotta find a nice, big, peaceful field or forest, and I don't know, be happy. Happy time.
Happy time.
Huh? Nowhere near these mean, stupid orcs. Ogre goblins. One of them. Goblins.
Hobgoblins.
That was it.
Make an influence check, Pumpkin. Let's see if you can convince the slave girl to come with.
Moo.
Alright, you do in fact moo convincingly. Like, anything's better than getting kidnapped again. Okay, I'll come with you, if you don't mind.
Sure. Is everyone else okay?
Yeah!
Yay! Hi!
Moo. Moo.
Hi.
Hazy will flip around. Why do you keep saying hi all the time?
Makes us happy.
Yo.
Mail?
Maybe later?
Okay.
There is a path leading up and away from the city that should hopefully get you around the worst of the hobgoblin patrols, if you so desire. And there's also an unconscious hobgoblin face down in the dirt.
Meh.
Well, we have to drop the other hobgoblins and tie them up.
That is a thing you could do. They are basically passed out at the moment, so They will offer little resistance.
Yay.
Excellent.
Bonk.
I got a rope.
I think I do too, but I use it for a grapple rope, because grappling is cool, and rogues' kits are the best.
Their dog nips and snarls at you when you bonk his masters, but can do nothing because he's all chained up.
Boop it, Snoot.
Boop it, Snoot.
That's the worst behind me. There's behind me. Behind me. I have to open up behind me.
If you haven't got any, I do have rope in this, apparently.
I got rope, so it's good.
Alright, you time up. No problemo.
Just wait.
The party encounters a group of strange people, and one of them is an ice blue lizard. No.
Just thrust that into Kinathis' game.
Huh? Oh.
We would all be into it, let's face it.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone gets free puppies. Puppies for everyone.
I don't like dogs. I really don't like dogs. Dogs don't like me.
No.
That's why I have cats.
All right, I guess we continue on.
Yeah, let's
go.
Do they have anything
useful?
When you Absalom the bodies, you find a total of 9 silver pieces, their weapons, which are swords and shields and a bow. And you also find a vial labeled Ogeron in one of their backpacks.
Ooh.
What's that?
Ogeron.
Major?
That's MooHiMe reading it. Ogeron.
Pumpkin, you don't know shit.
I...
It appears to be a creamy white vial filled with frothy, creamy liquid.
Ogeron. So it's like on an ogre or like
I've already been on a no-go. That wasn't great.
You hear the ogre sitting at the other end of camp just snort.
It was okay. It was messy.
It wasn't a minotaur, so...
True. Can I have the vial? You're already big and strong. Squeeze MooHiMe's biceps appreciatively.
Yes. They are prime beef here. Choice quality.
100% fucking beef.
No cake.
Yes. The primest moo cake.
Oh, man. I should have put freedom beef on the fucking encounter chart. Oh, well.
Freedom beef.
Snoo moo.
Freedom beef. Is that like... it was a gorilla cow that has buffed out really and running around with a cape made of, like, the U.S. flag and it's, like, camouflage painted?
It's so like that, except of bison tar. Or buffalo tar.
A merry flash.
Me want moose.
Freedom never reloads.
The liberty stake.
Alright, so. Since no one is stopping her, I guess Pumpkin will pocket the Ogeron vial.
Yeah, that'll make me all strong. Strong in a fight.
Yeah, totally.
Yep.
Always come. Could always be that.
That'd be refreshing mid-fight, too.
But it's still not a minotaur.
True.
Yeah.
Oh well. I'm not too fussed whoever has the silver. Boop. I've got a fierce 20 silver to my name. Bitches don't even know.
So much.
Yeah.
So.
Ping ping.
The party has a choice to make at this point as you mount the paths up out of the river valley. You can head westward, which would take you through the mountains and through a network of caves and tunnels, but it's a long way around, ultimately, uncharted territory by and large. Or you could go eastward through that mountain. This is the domain of the Minotaur King, where several of you likely came from. The paths are clear and well-defined, and while not patrolled by the hobgoblins, you are likely to bump into some Minotaurs. But it'll be a lot shorter.
Unless they want to keep us.
Well, you know, it's shorter in terms of time it will take you if you don't get kidnapped by Minotaurs.
Hmm. Yeah, the Minotaurs are in direction right. Snowball.
It's drink time, I'll be right back.
Wait.
Yeah.
We have a lady ogre here.
There is, in fact, a female ogre, or half-ogre, sitting near you.
Does she know the terrain and area?
She will shrug noncommittally. I've been there a few times, sure.
So you know how to get around without, like, they see you?
No. See, I work with a hobgoblin, so I don't mind if someone sees me. I just take the paths.
Well, that's just because you're huge.
Mm-hmm.
Like, really, really big.
It has come to my attention, yes.
That is very cool.
It's all right.
Can I get that big?
She sort of cocks her head to the side at you and looks you up and down. I don't know. Why don't you drink that? She just pokes at your stomach near where you've, like, put the ogre on your bandolier.
Back with
that'll make you big. It'll make you big.
Okay.
Wait.
She'll pop the cork and take a sip.
But you're a sneaky cow. If you're huge, everyone can see you.
I'm way better. I'm too good at sneaking anyway. It'll be fine.
Are you sure?
Yep, I have the nimbliest hooves.
More like the nimbliest hooves.
Nuh-uh.
If we put tiny little shoes on the hooves, then you become even quieter.
Probably. Swig.
Okay.
Alright, so how badly do I die?
Let's find out. Where is my macro? Or is it the F's? My macro appears not to be in the macro bar. That's unfortunate.
Well, I guess I explode and die.
Yeah, pretty much. Alright, roll for
the
character.
The macro isn't there.
No. Roll a d6. I do actually know how it works. It's just unfortunately I can't roll on the damn thing.
I think Fen's playing a charisma caster.
What?
Chat, you're so silly. Fen's playing as a suicide girl.
I'm playing as Aubrey Plaza.
Oh, you.
I'm playing a charisma caster.
Oh, that's right. Keen is an oracle.
My character has plate mail and a tower shield and a longsword.
And a Fen, you're playing as Grumpy Cow?
A little bit. Grumpy Law Cow.
My character is also a charisma caster. She's a bard.
A bard with a rocking strength score, if I recall correctly.
Yep, and an int of 5.
The most fucking incredibly jacked bard.
Alright, Pumpkin.
Hi.
You remember that big ogre you guys shot up to, was, you know, huge, muscly, burly, hairy motherfucker?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Well, you get one of those transformations, and the transformation you get is the hairy one.
What?
Your legs and arms become completely covered in thick, dense fur. A little poof floops up between your breasts.
Poofy.
And your hair lengthens and grows thick and shaggy and wild.
You know, when you said hairy TF, I'm glad that this was the result.
It could have gone another way, yeah.
It very well could have. Fortunately, you did not roll the masculinizing TF as well.
Now you're a fluffy cow.
What color are you?
Oh, I'm like a dark browny ginge. A bit rusty.
Yes, I have it. You have become this.
I know what picture this is. Yup.
Yes.
You are Fabio Cow now.
That is the most fabulous looking cow.
You're a floof cow now.
You are a floof cow now.
I love floof cows.
And cows have weird noses.
Cows have best noses.
They are delicious.
Oh, I bought steak when I got booze, too.
Oh, good move.
Yeah, steak tomorrow.
Nice. I hope it was a good steak as well.
Yeah,
it's just a tough old thing.
Just some New York strip.
Just some New York strip.
Hey, you said I'd get big! I mean, I'm floofy and cute again, but you know.
I can have a steak out after I go to the gym tomorrow.
The ogre just shrugs. Could have gotten big. Aww.
She's not gonna, no, she's not gonna keep, like, the incredibly long, she's gonna trip on it. She knows that she's gonna trip on it.
Alright, so. You have now acquired a much poofier cow, who has short hair again, but.
Floof poof.
Wait, if she's floofy and soft, does that mean that the floof dampens the sound and improves her sneaky?
You do not have floof on your hooves, unfortunately, so no. However, you will take one less point of damage from falling because you are that much bouncier and floofier. There you go.
Yay. I do bounce, then. I bounce for all to enjoy.
I give better hugs now.
Okay.
So. The question remains, will you go through the Minotaur's domain or brave the Uncharted Mountains?
I'm an adventurer, but I don't know.
Of course, we're adventurers.
Do we go adventure, or do we go Tallway?
We don't go to Minotaurs.
Okay.
Hazia nods enthusiastically. Yeah, that seems like a bad idea.
No.
Bah. She looks around, like, embarrassed when she just bad at you. Covers her mouth.
Too adorable.
No.
Can't stand it. Help.
Give her flu fucks.
I give her a flu fuck. Oh, she gets so floof-tugged.
So, how tall is Pumpkin?
Pumpkin is 5'5".
Alright, so she basically gets a face full of boob, because she's a tiny little thing.
And floof-hugs.
There's a moment of, like, flailing around, and then you feel something immensely strong just thump against your thigh.
Oh my.
Eyes widened.
You hear a little whimper and she just scrambles out of your arms and crosses her knees together. I gotta go to faith. Bye. She just starts scrambling off.
She gets like the sort of looking down the eyes like, I know what she's gonna go to. Well, no, I listen for the sound of thumping and baaing.
Let me know if you need any help.
You do not hear the sounds of thumping and baaing. Surprisingly, it seems she was just flustered.
Done.
Which way are we going?
Adventure way, not
snowball. Snowball.
No, snowball's where all the minotaurs are.
Oh.
Right. They're going other way.
Wait, so if Minotaur's a snowball,
snowball,
then this is what? This is what then?
All snow. It's like snowball, but the other side.
Yeah, but snow, no, points northward. That is snow, and that is ball. So if we go snowball, it's that way, see? So we have to be the opposite of ball.
Square snow?
God damn it.
No.
Snow square?
Cube.
Snow cube. Okay.
Yes.
What's a cube?
It's like a ball, but cubey.
It's like a boob, but gross looking.
No.
No. A cube is like a box.
I like boxes.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of boxes.
But all sides are the same way. So it's cube.
Snow cube, let's go.
We go cube first, then snow cube.
All right. Why don't one of you give me a survival check to see if you can in fact find your way cube then snow cube.
A survival, you say?
I'm a bard, I can help with this.
Damn, son. You did good there.
Cinnamon!
No!
Lilia just waves as the party departs.
Bye!
Take care, big lady.
You too. Try not to get, yeah, you'll be fine. And thus the party advances. Alright, and Cinnamon, since you rolled the survival check, why don't you roll me a d20? Congratulations, nothing untoward happens for the rest
Yay.
Of the day. As you make your way into the mountains. Unfortunately, however, as night begins to fall and you start advancing up the mountain paths, you hear the rumble of thunder once more from overhead. Looks like another storm front's moving in.
Rain.
Oh. I don't like rain.
All right. Tents. The party sets up camp for the night. Let's see. Well, that survival check, you can probably find like a little cavern or something to get some extra shelter in, or maybe a rocky outcropping.
Yeah.
Stave off the worst of the rain for those of you who can't fit in the two tents I believe you have.
Yep.
Because yeah, you now have too many people.
Cuddle harder.
I was sore. I actually can fit more than like two people in my, because I don't have a small, I have a medium tent.
Ah, okay, that works. How many people can you fit in your tent?
Let me tab over. I could look at gear. Where's my tent? Let's see.
You have, I believe, 9 people that need to be fit into tents.
So, a small tent can hold one medium creature normally, but you can squeeze 2 in. A medium tent can hold 2 medium creatures, so you can squeeze 3 in.
Okay, so you have enough room for like 5 people?
Intense, yes.
Alright, so, actually.
I see what you mean by snow and ball now. Okay. Mm-hmm. I get it now.
Yay.
Boom.
What?
Alright, so figure out where you're sleeping. I guess Cinnamon has the meat, or no, it's MooHiMe has the medium tent, and then, was it Pumpkin who had the small tent?
Yep, it's got little moo cows printed on it.
Adorable.
Now the question is, though, which ones are the one who's most naked?
Well, the hobgoblin slave is buck naked, so... Also, she will introduce herself as Tamika.
Hi. And then she'll get 10 minutes of hi in response.
Hi, and moves.
Yep.
Because, okay, Reaha, she needs to be in tent. Naked, Tamika needs to be in tent.
Alright, that's one tent full.
I don't need a tent. I'm hardy.
Hazia will say that she can survive outside.
No, wait.
It's fine.
No, it's not that. It's that MooHiMe is not gonna be in the tent. Because she has light armor, and she has clothes, and she has a cloak. Yes, cloak. I did say cloak, right?
Yeah, I can probably sleep in my armor too, but whatever, I have a tent, I'm gonna enjoy. Yeah.
So, she makes sure that all those that need to be inside that are almost naked can be, or that needs to soak and not get rain on them.
Alrighty. So, basically, MooHiMe, Bessie, and Hazia will all be outside for the night.
Yay.
Okay.
I got a cloak, so...
Alright.
And I have a bedroll, so we can use that as a makeshift shelter. If you spread it out a bit.
Smart.
Alright, so... Follow-up question. Who's on first, second, and third watch?
I'll take third for once. I didn't take a watch last time.
Okay. You and Dallas can be first on that watch together. Right. MooHiMe's on first.
I can go second.
All right. Cinnamon's on second. Bessie, are you going to take a watch?
Fen?
Yes.
I'm staying up anyway, so.
All right. Which watch?
I'll take first.
All right. Cool. So MooHiMe and Bessie, then Cinnamon, then Pumpkin and Dallas. Sweet.
Uh-oh. We get attacked by 3 moolets.
Yep. All right, everyone.
Oh, we're dead.
It's 3 moolets, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
All,
in fact, 3 moolets. Giant, heavily armored freedom beefs.
Yeah. No. Moolets are just
they got party, but it's party in the back and business in the front.
Oh, God.
Could just, like, never say that to me again.
I like it.
Pumpkin, since it's your watch that's getting attacked, why don't you roll me a d10?
Whose watch is it? Is that happening during second?
It's happening during your watch.
Alright, d10.
That's yep. Sick. But we didn't... It was a Sav&D.
What?
That's your name. Fenox and I didn't do perception rolls and stuff for...
Nothing came our watch, anywhere near your watch. So...
Oh,
good. Uh-oh.
Cool. All right. This is a good result. We'll assume these guys are somewhere near the little entrance to this area. Probably is. Actually, no, they're asleep, so. Boop, boop. Pumpkin and Dallas.
Hi.
Are up an atom.
Bessie, Bessie, and I are together, so makeshift protect from rain.
Alright. That works. You guys are cuddled up over there. So, Pumpkin and I think Shou is still AFK, so rip. Actually, I have a character sheet. I can just roll 4.
Yay.
Characters. Battle Cattle. Dallas. Character sheet. So roll me a perception check. Let's
oh,
see.
Good. Perception.
Yeah. At least it's not minus Moo.
Oh, shit. I have -2, but instead of minus Moo, but I still did good.
Let's see. Perception. 14. All right.
Well, she has 3 positive wisdom for perception. That's bullshit.
I know, right?
No, she just got class for it.
Right, yeah, bard's a decent. Well, rogues are supposed to be. I just don't have the necessary to have decent skill points. Perception is one of the ones that fell by the wayside.
Do 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 do. All right, Pumpkin. As you are glancing towards the entrance to the little valley that you've taken shelter in, you see a mighty destrier clomping around through the muck in the rain, but the rider is sitting much too far forward for it to be a true warhorse. Now, as you squint your eyes, you realize that there's a centaurus plodding around not that far away from you. Ooh. Doesn't seem like she's noticed your party, but she is most certainly armed.
Clumping around.
That's a lot.
How does she look?
Well, it's the middle of the night and it's pouring rain out, so you can't really get a good look at her from this distance. You'd have to get a little closer.
All right, gonna sneaky sneak.
All right.
Oh, I'm not.
So you immediately trip over some of your new floof and just go face planting into the dirt. Sploosh.
Oh my.
You hear a gasp of surprise and a pair of mighty hoof beats clomp towards you.
Oh, now my floof is all dirty again.
You're filthy. Yes. White. The centaurus glances down at you from her very high vantage point, almost 10 feet up in the air, and pokes at you with one of her hooves as she approaches. You okay down there?
Yeah, I tripped. Trying to wipe some dirt and stuff away. My name's Pumpkin, what's yours?
She blinks a moment. You can talk?
Yep. Hi.
Huh. She reaches down and offers you a hand up, first and foremost.
She doesn't realize that Pumpkin stood up, she's just that short, like, huh, I can't go up more.
So it's like she tries to pull you up and then your hooves just sort of flail in the air. It's, oh, you're just a tiny little thing, aren't you?
I'm sure.
Well, I'm Bianca, a tracker.
Bianca Beauchamp?
Yes. She certainly has the figure of Bianca Beauchamp.
Woo!
Let me tell you. Though she is dusky-skinned with a long braid of caramel hair spilling well down her back. And
oh,
she is
shit,
wearing...
she got candy hair?
Yeah. And
oh,
she is wearing
shit,
basically
boy.
Nothing except for a silken blanket on her back and a very colorful shield strapped to one arm. Plus a bit of jewelry here and there.
Yep.
So she's much more bare-breasted than even the cowgirls.
Hi, I'm Pumpkin. Over there's Dallas.
Dallas presumably waves.
Dallas does wave.
Oh, hello. Shows back. Hello.
Hello.
It was during our watch that we see a centaur lady. She's got
hello.
Fucking humongous jubblies.
Yes. Immense.
Wide eyes. Staring.
Where did you come from?
Village back that away. And a bunch of cowgirls who can all talk?
Yep.
Hi.
It's kind of dangerous for you all to be out here, don't you think? Minotaurs might just swoop you up.
Psh, we're adventurers.
Yeah, but... okay.
She'll pat a fluffy bicep.
What? Just...
hello.
Talking?
Hello.
The centaur
hello?
Looks over. Oh, there's more of you.
Yep.
Meow.
I'd say a regular old herd, huh?
Yo.
I think some of them are still sleeping, though.
Shh.
Oh, sorry.
One of them is pregnant, so she needs to rest.
Sorry, I didn't mean to disturb anybody. I just... saw tracks leading in this direction. Thought I might be on the tail of my prey. Seems I was mistaken, though, so I'll leave you to it.
What prey?
What prey? I don't suppose a lot of you have seen. She'll look around sort of warily for a moment. I don't suppose you've seen a lizard folk. Running around, a woman with green scales but hair made of moss coming down from, well, all over her, really.
Nope.
Well, if you do, avoid her at all costs. She's an assassin. She killed our tribe's chieftain.
Why?
I don't know, but I'd certainly like to find out. And she cracks her knuckles.
What's an assassin?
She sort of blinks at you.
It's a
murderer.
Blood specialist.
An ass.
I like my better. Yeah. Because you get ass and ass in, you get the perfect shape, so you get the butt specialist.
Mm-hmm.
So they like butts.
Yep.
We cannot lie.
Yes.
Okay.
Right, just that, but not at all that. She's a murderer. She kills people for a living, I think.
What a bitch.
That's not nice.
I mean, Moo.
Bianca nods and crosses her arms. Like I said, keep on the lookout for and any other lizard folk. They're dangerous
okay.
out in these parts.
Dangerous.
She nods firmly and turns to leave.
Huh.
Why are you going?
Well, unless you have the assassin here, then I'm no closer to finding her now than I was before.
Rest!
No rest.
But it's night.
Yes, that means I can cover more ground.
Milk?
But it's late.
What? She turns to Pumpkin when she offers milk.
Yeah, before you go.
No.
What?
Good.
Roll influence, Pumpkin. Plus Moo.
Plus your Moo.
Yes, plus Moo.
17.
Well, I mean, it is very hospitable of you. So I'll start cantering back in your direction.
Yep.
I guess, I mean, I did startle you into the dirt. At least I can do is help you milk.
Yeah, they're very heavy.
I bet. So, boop. Bianca and Pumpkin go off to attend to some lactic needs.
Yay.
Anybody else in the party have anything they'd like to do while that is ongoing?
No. I don't think so. I don't have anything to do.
Just...
Yeah, I'm good.
Keep watch.
Is everyone a lesbian now? Because that could be dangerous for traps.
Alright, so a few minutes pass in quiet company for Pumpkin and Bianca. For the centaurus reappears from the brush with a hefty milk mustache, and Pumpkin, a moment later, looks much smaller breasted.
Much better.
Moo.
They were heavy. Bye.
Goodbye, little cow. I hope you and your friends have a safe journey.
Oh, yeah. We're big and strong.
She just chuckles from her massive vantage point and canters her enormous warhorse butt off. Boop. And the rest of the night passes peacefully.
Pumpkin will at some point give herself another rigorous cleaning.
So much floof.
So much floof.
Gotta stay on top of that show. You smell bad. Don't smell bad.
Unfortunately, the storm persists into the next day as you look towards the mountaintops. If you want to get through, you'll have to climb despite the inclement weather. Potentially dangerous, but what other choice do you have?
We're adventurers.
You are.
I actually have, like, climbing gear. I literally have grappling hooks, ropes, and pittons.
Well, that's probably gonna help.
Literally have fucking pittons for scaling stuff. Which will, yeah.
And we have a goat to instruct us on how to climb better.
Yay.
Hazy will nod enthusiastically. So, to start things off, would everyone make an athletics check to start finding their way up the handholds and ropes? Move forcefully.
Not bad for someone with negative one strength.
There we go. I need three more rolls from the party, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Or two more rolls, rather.
Bessie Fen.
What are we rolling?
Athletics to mountain climb.
Okay.
Would that just be climb? Because I'm using the thing on Silken.
I think there's a tab for consolidated skills.
Turns out armor check penalty and athletics do not go well.
There isn't a consolidated tab that I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Was it? There used to be, at least on the other Pathfinder sheet there was.
Well, let me make sure I use the right attribute.
It is Lestrange for athletics.
Oh, so, yeah, no difference.
Also, you apparently have rolled a negative 30.
Yeah, all that armor check penalty.
Oh, fuck.
Tower shield's minus 10.
But are you literally climbing with it out? You only get that if you have it equipped. You can just toss that over your back.
Well, in that case, it'd be like my armor's still on, so what's that? -4. So, in that case, it'd be 14.
Alright.
I got a 9.
So, unfortunately, certain members of the party are a bit of a drag on the rest of you. Hazia has to spend a lot of time, like, putting her ram horns right up against your ass and pushing you up the mountain. Especially poor Bessie, who's just weighed down by all this armor.
That's fine.
But with Cinnamon and MooHiMe make pretty good time. Cinnamon and MooHiMe make good time. Pumpkin, you think you could have made better time, but you know your ropes are being used by the entire party at this point. It's not great progress you're making. So, while you're climbing, would everyone make a nature check?
Clamoring
up, you start realizing, whew, it's getting awful cold up here.
I got an 11.
That's what, an intelligence skill?
Yes.
Yeah.
3.
Alright. Good job, party.
No.
So, you fail to realize that the winds are picking up until it's too late, that the rain is getting colder and colder, until as you get about halfway up the mountain, it turns to snow, and a harsh downpour, too, almost like a blizzard.
Don't worry, they're patching forever.
Unfortunately, you need to find somewhere to shelter from this blizzard. There's no way you can progress up the mountain at this rate. You'll just be blown off the side.
Mm-hmm.
Would one of you make me a survival check?
Oh god, not me.
In this case, whoever makes it will have advantage because Hazia is a mountain goat and all about that shit.
Okay.
All about
I can do that. Survival, I don't have a lot, but I have something.
I have -2, so...
Kinathis, do you have what, like plus what?
+4.
Well, it's one better than me, so don't set advantage.
I will try.
Shit!
Oh shit!
You find El Dorado.
You literally find El Dorado. No, but you do find a cave that is deep and, as far as you can see, free of traps. There is no tunnel down to Goblin Town or anything.
Yay!
Cursory Goblin inspection reveals. Down to Goblin Town. God, I love that scene.
Yeah,
it's
still my favorite.
All right. So, you push the party into the caves where they will be relatively safe for the moment. But as you are getting into the cave, clambering up off the side of the mountain, you hear the rumble of thunder and a peal of lightning strikes down from on high.
Lightning's peeing.
Yes, lightning is peeing. Unfortunately, it pees right onto your climbing rope, and with a ka-thump of force, it snaps, and several of you are suddenly much less secure on the mountainside.
Oops.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Bessie, MooHiMe, and Dallas, would you all make finesse checks to try and find a handhold or some other way to grab onto something to save yourselves before you go tumbling?
Dexterity, I'm
assuming. Dexterity, yeah, for you.
Okay. Let's see. What's my finesse?
I guess that's just dex.
Probably.
Any skill I didn't take, I didn't write down.
Alright, good shot, Barty. And MooHiMe.
So, bearers then. No, this isn't Canada's best-selling novel.
Alright. Today is the day of rolling sub-10s.
Everyone dies. Cows fall. The end.
Alright. The three of you go tumbling. Fortunately, there is an outcropping of rock that you manage to slam your backs onto. So each of you are going to take 4 points of falling damage. Crunch. And you are badly dazed by
the fall. Wait, what about... Didn't soft cow be like 1 point less?
Are you soft? Are any of the three of you soft cow?
I'm fine. I wasn't.
Yeah, pumpkin's fine. She got into the cave.
I'm floofy.
Okay.
No.
So, you spend a moment recovering, but the party is now separated by about 20 feet of sheer surface, without climbing gear and with a blizzard pounding down around you. What do you do?
Moo.
Moo.
This seems like a good plan.
Moo. Mm.
I am an adventurer to the rescue. I will, now that we're actually in a cave thing, I will set up the old fucking grapple hook.
All right. You set up your grappling hook. Unfortunately, most of your rope has been snapped and burned away by the lightning strike.
I have a rope.
I got rope.
Didn't you use your rope tying up the goblins? Or do you have another one?
Oh, right.
Cinnamon has rope. Cinnamon
has rope.
Cinnamon ropes.
All right. Cinnamon, you hand over your rope, and Pumpkin is able to toss a rope down. Yay.
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 Now what are you going to do with it?
Lean out and go, hi.
Wow.
Good job. Good
hi.
Job. So two parties stare at each other and say hi.
Do you want me to come? Do you want me to come down and help?
Come help would be nice.
I'm going to try and tie the rope into a harness because I've seen these, because I know how these work.
We should
use them for fucking, right?
You know, you use them for leading cows.
Oh God, of course.
So I'm assuming that'll be a dex.
Yeah, I think that makes sense.
I got an 18.
All right, you managed to tie your rope up. Get yourselves ready to get led on up the mountainside.
Okay, let's see here. Am I allowed to be acrobatic instead of athletic, or do I just really have to haul some there?
I think this is going to be a hauling, so probably raw strength.
I can help.
My raw strength is my athletics.
Fair enough. Yeah, if you want to help Cinnamon, you can also roll a strength check.
Strength check.
Mm-hmm. All right. Pumpkin, pick two cows from down below.
Okay. On the list, it would appear to be MooHiMe and Bessie.
Alright, MooHiMe and Bessie get hauled up. But unfortunately, Bessie's heavy armor and the inclement winds cause too much strain on the rope. It snaps.
Oh.
But the two of them are able to get up before poor Dallas goes flopping onto her back again.
Oh.
And is stranded once more at the bottom.
More rope?
Moo.
Dallas, make me a perception check.
No.
Okay. I'm kind of good at this if I remember right. Nope. I'm kind of... Oh, I got a 23.
23,
alright. Oh, yeah, no, you're shit at perception.
I got a net 20.
Moo.
Alright, with a natural 23, as you're flailing around on this little rocky outcropping... Your back presses up against the wall, and suddenly you realize, ew, what's that slimy thing? You turn around and see that there's some sort of hideous green fungus growing all along the rock face near where you're standing. And it seems to be leading into a very tight crevasse. You rack your tiny little cow brain and remember hearing something about an assassin lizard covered in moss?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. You don't suppose she's up here? Oh, no.
Oh, no.
She's going to come out and touch your butt. In a bad way.
I'm going to panic.
Panicked moves.
That does sound like what assassins do.
Panicked moves.
No.
Yes, moo internally. Alright, so Dallas, what do other than moo?
Moo.
Alright, take a point to moo for yourself. You just sit there and panically moo.
I have an int of 5. She's not doing shit.
Wow.
Alright.
So, wow.
What?
The rest of the party, you see Dallas start to just owl moos in panic and flail around.
Oh, I'm terrible at climbing without the ropes.
No. Just. How far down is she?
She is 20 feet down.
Okay. Well, Jaime, do we have any rope?
Nope. I've lost mine. Nothing. Cinnamon's is gone.
I have an adventuring pack, which probably has rope, so...
It does!
Let's just use that.
Alright, I have your last rope.
I also
you guys
have
break
rope.
This, I'm gonna rip out your tails and make a new one.
No.
Oh,
but it's so floofy now!
It's worth noting that I believe Dallas has, what is it, splint mail armor on, so she's heavy as shit. Rope breakage is possible.
Yeah, but I'm strong as shit.
Yeah, we have the Mooist on our side now.
It's true.
Alright, I guess we all do athletics and just fucking haul ass.
Yeah, everyone make a strength check.
Strength, you're saying?
Athletics, it is.
Yeah, they're identical to me.
Whoops, that's supposed to be a 1.
Either way.
But regardless, you roll deep.
Yep. Right, with some effort, the party is able to hook a rope around Dallas since she's much too panicked to do it herself and haul her up the mountainside. The rope very nearly snaps, but you are able to pull her up before any damage is done to it.
Sally up, down, Sally down.
And Dallas is once calmed by some gentle suckling from Rhea's honey boobs, is able to regale you with the tale of horrible, nasty, icky goop that's now all over her. Since you basically just dragged her up the side of the mountain, so you are covered in this mossy shit.
I'm sure it's fine.
Excellent.
It's literally, that's, by the way, is my thing's weakness is that I'm just fucking careless as shit, so. Just, whatever.
Yep. Yeah, it's fine.
Pull out the cow blanket and make a fire, I guess.
Burn your blanket? Oh no.
No. I'm gonna. Goodness, no.
You guys are morons.
Hey, that's not nice.
That's why
you
I said it.
Fell. I didn't.
I did.
Boo.
No,
boo. It's like bat and moo at the same time.
You hear a bat from somewhere deeper in the cavern?
I will follow the sounds of batting.
You find Hazia sitting against the side of the wall and sort of drawing on it with a piece of chalk she's found somewhere.
Please help. If I die in this cave, I died with idiots.
You pretty much. You don't know what she's drawing, but it seems to be some sort of strange characters that you've never seen before. Perhaps these things called the written word.
Pretty sure it's wizard shit.
It's absolutely wizard
there
shit.
There you go, it's wizard shit. You're a wizard!
Ah, no. Just drawing.
Oh, okay.
The written word. I know what that is.
Have you followed Pumpkin in to check on Hazy, I guess?
Everyone walks in because it's cold outside, maybe.
Oh god, hold on. One second.
It's high move.
God damn it.
God damn it.
Oh, chat.
And the weather outside is frightful.
So what language do you read, MooHiMe?
She reads cow. Damn it!
Common? That's it. Let me get the list here. Magic, personal. Okay.
And the mooing is so
common,
delightful.
Cowgirl, and I could take two, what was the word? Languages.
Well, what languages did you take? Also, you can't
Dwarven
read...
and Talir.
What was the first one?
Dwarven.
Okay. So no, you do not recognize the characters she's writing in, but you do know that she is writing words.
I ask her then, what words are she writing?
Just my name, to say I was here. In case we, you know, die, and I guess no one would come looking for us, but, you know, if they did.
Why would we die in here?
We're adventurous.
Protective. Yeah.
But there's monsters up here, and the blizzard, and we could all starve to death.
No.
We got food.
Yeah, but for how long?
We're not staying here long. Just a day, and then we go.
But the blizzard, it could last for like a week.
No.
No. Just holds up her boobs and says, see, we get food for days here, and then just points out everyone else, and then more days there, and then more there, and then we get food.
Oh dear.
See? I presumably don't know shit about the weather with a 10.
Weather's dumb. It rains and makes me sad, and then it snows and it makes me cold.
All you know is that it is a freak autumn blizzard going on outside.
It'll be fine.
Old man winter needs laid.
Old man winter is getting laid right now. It's busy in old man winter's bedroom right now.
Is that how that works?
Well.
I heard winter is an elf who lives on an island and sends all the storms to punish people.
No. Everyone knows elves aren't real.
That sounds sort of right. I believe it.
Hazy just nods enthusiastically. And that's what my mom said. She knew lots of stuff.
Okay. Pumpkin seems content with that answer. She knows. I know someone who knows things.
I wish my mom knew something.
Good enough, Pumpkin.
She knows how to moo, I guess.
And milk. She will jam the fucking fawn into milk.
But yeah, but anybody can milk. That's easy.
True.
If it has nipples, it can milk.
Hazy glances around awkwardly.
She's being jammed into chest. Moo.
No, I can't moo or milk.
Milk.
Fix that.
What? You feel that thump against your thigh again as you boob press?
We just have to suck on your nipples every couple hours. It'll happen.
That's okay. That's okay.
It'll be fun.
Good idea.
You'll like it. It'll feel great.
No. I'm okay.
No.
Bah. Not moo. Bah.
Oh, man.
She struggles feebly against Pumpkin's firm grasp. Pumpkin, make a... Oh, are you singing the song of your people?
I'm singing the song of my people.
You trying to, like, lull her down like a lullaby?
Yes. She's panicking, so I shall move the song of our people.
Oh, my God. All right. just gonna have her make a will save.
Oh, man.
Let's see. Where is her stat block? Poor little ram. Oh boy, it's a stalemate. She seems unconvinced by all of this and continues to weakly struggle, especially when people start talking about sucking on her nipples. However,
even if I'm mooing the song of my people and have a moo.
Yes, even with your moo. However, you feel this intense throbbing against your thigh, the familiar hardness tenting her poor little skirt. Nobody else can see it, but by God, you feel it. And the desire to do your cowly duty becomes quite intense. Make a will save.
To know more, intensify.
That was a finesse check to get a hand over there.
Oh, well, all right then. So you're finessing it, so I guess the rest of the party isn't going to see that shit. Yep. Hazy just completely tenses up in your arms. Ah, papa!
Moo.
Moo. Moo.
She squirms feebly. Pumpkin, let's see. Why don't you make a... Do-do-do-do. Where are my mechanics at? There you go.
Stealth hand jobs are strong.
Yeah, if you want to be stealthy, I think a stealth hand job might be the way to go. Roll that stealth. Uh-oh. So, unfortunately, Hazia is not a quiet play, as you might have gathered from her bleating. And once you start massaging the quite sizable tool she appears to be packing, she manages to twist herself in such a way that all of a sudden, rather than a pin between your thighs, it springs out between your bodies. And everyone is suddenly drawing their attention towards the only dick in the room.
Hello? Hello?
She bleats and desperately, like, covers herself with both hands, pushing down as hard as she can, and achieving very little success.
Cock like that needs to breathe.
No, it needs to go back down. Go away.
I'll help.
No, don't eat me. Don't eat me.
Why would we eat you?
She, like, goes completely limp in Pumpkin's arms, like, trying to assume the fetal position, but can't because she's being held up.
Okay, then. There's gonna be some adjustment done until she assumes an entirely different form of this.
Alright, what position are you trying to get poor Hazian? Just for clarification.
We like to call this move the lay down by the fire.
Okay, just checking. And it could have easily just as been assumed the savvy position, so you know.
Yeah, well, I mean, it could also have been perform a sharpshooter or something, I don't know.
Alright, so you lay her down by the fire, and she just, like, curls up on herself, trying to contain her massive erection, and not succeeding at all. Now that you have a good look at it, it appears to be at least a good foot and a half long, which, considering she's probably less than 5 feet tall, is quite something.
She's probably going to find a moo on it in a second.
No.
She is desperately trying to stow it and not succeeding. What do? Actually, Pumpkin, no. Everyone make a will save. Because for the first time in days, you have access to cock.
Oh, boy.
And, you know, you're starting to smell some distinctly male aromas wafting up from that skirt.
It's fine. I'm just going to suck this for a little bit.
Just gonna handle that one there. This is literally like you open the room and all the eyes turn to face you. Turn.
Alright, cinnamon is good.
The holy cow's got that shit under control.
Yeah.
Mine should technically be an 8.
Excellent.
Because my moo is 3 right now. So it should be probably minus my moo.
Okay, so now you fail. So, let's see, MooHiMe and Pumpkin. I believe we need some will saves.
Will save, okay.
Yep, will save to resist the draw of cock. Excellent.
Nope.
Oh. All right, so...
I did not expect that turnout.
So, versus the DC of 10, Cinnamon and Pumpkin managed to compose themselves somewhat. Dallas, Bessie, and MooHiMe, however, cannot possibly resist the intense pheromonic urges that are pulsing through their tiny little cow brains. And before poor Hazia can do anything to save herself, her skirt is being ripped off and 3 cows are sucking down on her rod. Which, you quickly note, is attached to a pair of tanuki-sized balls that have been pent up for days.
So, I want to tell you that I imagine that this cock is in front of her face. She stares at it for a few seconds, and then you hear, nomph, as, mouth closes around it.
Can I use my tower shield to try and block it off so that only I get it?
Yes, you can. Let's see, why don't you roll me an athletics check versus one made by MooHiMe and Dallas.
Okay, so that's
as she tries to quite literally cock block you. Alright, so
you can't defeat the Moos.
So what happens is Dallas hops onto the crown. Hazia starts yelping and kicking her little goat horns and feet. Then Alice is immediately just like shield shoved off of the deck and goes rolling off into the side. MooHiMe just like drop kicks the shield out of the way and plants herself on some deck.
Nice.
Yes, gonna be sucked nice and deep.
Don't eat me!
This is kind of eating you want.
It's kind of like a real fun version.
This is good.
Pumpkin's been fawn cuckolded, and she will go sit by her fire with her blanket and pout.
I mean, you could get on that cock voluntarily, you just might take some moo.
This is the first dick my character's had. Back off.
She knows she got something, and she's apparently not losing her fucking shit at the sight of Ween.
So MooHiMe, do you share with Sigrid and Dallas?
With Sigrid? Sigrid, what are you doing here?
God damn it!
Sorry.
With Bessie and Dallas.
Dallas is probably still swollen from ogre killer, so.
Well, we are adventurers together, so we have to work together. And it would be better if there's 3 of us instead of just 1.
Yes.
Right?
Teamwork and friendship for boning.
Yes.
Wow.
Excellent.
Friendship is moo.
So, 3 cows work together in perfect harmony after a little bit of vetching and shield bashing to quickly and almost effortlessly bring the poor little ram girl to orgasm, which erupts in a fountain of white cream that quite literally hits the ceiling before raining down on all of you. Skaploosh.
Would the mouths be in the way?
Can I use the underside?
You start with mouths in the way until you're blasted off by the pressure.
Can I use my tower shield to catch and funnel?
Yes, absolutely.
Are you like beer bonging it?
Sorry. So Dallas and MooHiMe get a face full of it before getting blasted off. And then Bessie starts beer bonging the rain. Excellent.
Do I get a point of moo for that?
Yes, you get the moo.
I swear that's too genius to earn a point of moo.
I say if someone asks for moo, they get the moo.
That's true. That was like straight up Jizz MacGyver. Well done.
Yeah. Nothing is as come hungry as a needy cow.
Sure.
I've done this jizz in a plastic explosive.
Once it's all over, Bessie will burp and then pat the girl's balls and tell her that was acceptable.
She just trembles and like one little touch just sends a squirt up into the air and just splats you on the face.
See, nobody's getting eaten.
Don't say it. Didn't warn you.
About what?
Nigel's the demon's god.
Having an acceptable orgasm?
Moo.
Would the three of you roll me a fortitude save?
Moo.
Uh-oh.
Okay. I got 20.
Excellent. Actually, I need a second one from you, Shou, for other reasons.
I got a 20.
All right, then.
Nice.
16.
All right.
There, I'll change to Bessie too, so I'll stop showing up Sig, because that's annoying me too.
I appreciate it. So, Bessie, just as she says, "Don't say I didn't warn you," you feel an intense burning sensation in your loins.
Mm-hmm.
Followed by one growing through your stomach, then just into your mind itself. Just a searing, lusty heat.
Okay.
You need more. Much, much more.
Oh, well, if I squeeze your balls, I can have more.
Yes. Yes, you can have more. And in fact, you do have more, as you immediately plant yourself cunt first on that rod. Take it up to the hilt and start pounding away. Make a will save.
Bad end.
Whoops, why did I do 2d20? Whatever, I got the 20.
All right.
God damn, we're all amazing at fucking, but terrible at climbing shit. Just abysmal at climbing, but so good at laying.
So three internal cum shots later, you manage to pull yourself off of the poor little ram girl just as your belly is getting so bloated that you're not entirely convinced you can walk. But her balls have now shrunk down to tiny little tennis balls that are just so empty comparatively that the poor thing can barely think anymore. Her eyes have just crossed and she's flopped onto her back, breathing hard. You pull yourself off, leaking profusely, and feel something burning in your crotch still. The need isn't gone, but the body is soft and squishy and can no longer function.
The spirit is willing, but the body is soft and easily bruised.
So, you're going to gain another point of moo, and you have entered your heat phase.
Woo!
The desire for cum is incredibly strong right now.
I believe I need more cock.
We don't have any more.
It's a good thing I got this cum pass before today.
That expired.
Didn't that run out?
Fry squint. Don't say that.
I can't feel my legs.
She will receive milk.
So, by the time that's happened, the rest of the party has more or less slept through the night. And dawn is coming. Well, dawn is one of the many things coming at this point. But when the party reconvenes, gathers themselves up, Bessie is looking quite hot under the collar, and poor Hazia is incredibly embarrassed looking, but seems to be moving a little bit quicker now, so she's no longer being burdened by several pounds of spooge. And the blizzard is still going on outside.
Alright, I should probably take rations off. And yes. People have how many rations?
I have an adventurer's pack.
I have enough for 8 more days.
Okay. I'll give one to Hazia and one to Hobgoblin, and I've got 11.
Hazia consumes your entire ration in about 2 bites and makes a very unladylike belch, and then you hear her knees just slam together as something happens below the skirt.
Oof. Da-da-da! Da-da-da!
The Hobgoblin, however, is a much more delicate eater and will gratefully accept whatever you give her.
Yep.
You ready also, for round 2? Like, yes.
Since she's like still naked, I'd probably let her use the... I let her use my moo cow face's blanket.
Aw, how sweet of you. She is very appreciative of that and will give you a big hug when you offer to let her wrap up in your blanket, because...
Will save versus how wonderfully floofy I am to ever leave again.
Nope, she clings to you like a Conan girl. Just once she realizes how warm and fluffy you are, oh god, no, get a crowbar. So,
fluffy.
She is now bolted onto you.
A crowbar? We get a crowbar.
you got enough leverage with that fawn. You can peel away.
Poor Hazia.
No, but MooHiMe asks if they've got milk buckets.
I do. I have actually got a pail.
Good.
Indeed, it's written in my inventory bucket in an initial description. It's called a pail, you pleb. Not even kidding.
Okay, because MooHiMe hasn't been milked in 2 days.
I will provide milk bucket.
Moo.
Moo.
Moo. No, wait, longer. Her boobs are... dreaming.
Poor thing. Everybody's getting so pent up. Need to find some monsters to just bang you into submission.
No.
And take all that juicy, juicy milk.
Hmm. Do we wait for the blizzard, or do we just go?
Well, we can manage a little bit more. We can just rest up. Take care.
Okay.
Alright.
I mean, Pumpkin seems happy to just floofy blanket spoon with people all day.
So, alright, the party's gonna take a day off and hope the blizzard passes. So, Bessie, when you say, are you ready for round 2, poor Hazia just shakes her head as violently as she can. No, I'm okay. I'm fine now.
You're the best around. Nothing's ever gonna keep it down.
Oh, wow.
And a few moments later,
one
let's see.
Eternity later.
Yes. Dallas.
Wait. Yes.
I have an idea.
Okay.
I have a really good idea. Do you still have those berries?
The ones that make strawberry milk?
Nobody harvested any of those. Dallas ate them all.
No, no, other berries. Didn't we, like, get some berries and stuff that wasn't the strawberries making milk?
You didn't, like, collect any that you didn't eat right away.
Okay, because we got cold and stuff, so we can make ice cream.
Oh. I have strawberry milk.
Oh, do you still have a bottle
milk?
Of it?
I still have 2 bottles of it.
Oh, yeah. Ice cream. And then we pour it into with the milk from MooHiMe, who's not way smaller. Quite a few liters.
So, the party takes the first part of the day off from adventuring. Because fuck that, fuck this danger, fuck this weather. We're going to sit here and make ice cream.
Going to have ice cream and spoon.
Yeah.
We're going to have ice cream, we're going to cuddle, and we're going to fuck up the one and only dick we can get access to.
Well, yeah. The Hobgoblin has a dick.
Does she?
Oh,
does she?
No. I was thinking of the Hobgoblin that we took prisoner.
No, you guys left him, I believe. Or no one said they were taking him, so. I think everyone's going to get a point of moo for just surrendering to the careless, happy cow inside all of us.
I just got like 3 moo in like 2 seconds.
Well,
yay.
You mooed.
This is bullshit. I was just thirsty.
You mooed.
Speaking of thirsty, make a will save minus moo, Bessie.
Uh-oh. You're about to fucking be such a Bessie rape. Oh,
yep.
No.
So, while the rest of the party is off making ice cream, Bessie, you happen to find poor Hazia when no one else is around. And
it was her first mistake.
Yep. And then you're in the back of the cavern dragging her off. Meanwhile, Dallas.
We want snoo snoo! Oh!
The rest of the party just hears a faint bah! Just echoing into the distance.
They've gotten far enough in now that it's literally just a resigned.
Oh, wow.
Dallas.
Yes.
As you are outside making ice cream with the rest of the party, you wander out for a few moments into the bit of a blizzard to get some, you know, get the cold air running. And you suddenly notice out here in the light, oof, you feel a lot more energized. Hey, this feels great. What's going on here? Then you look up, and some of your hair is, you know, blasted into your eyes by those winds. And you notice that it's turned a dark green color all of a sudden. Who, what? A thick, mossy green color.
Wait, who's got green hair?
Dallas.
Oh, okay. Thought somehow just banging the shit out of this sheep was making my hair green. Just gonna freak out.
Moo.
So, you have green hair, and being in the light seems to make you feel a lot more active and energized for the moment.
Are you photosynthesizing?
Probably. So she's gonna run back to the group, and she's hyper as shit. And that sucks for you guys, because she's dumb as a brick.
She's dumb as a brick and has enormous, completely green eyes now. No whites at all, no irises, no nothing, just green.
No! Whoa.
Bella, your eyes changed.
No.
I don't know that I have anything reflective. Well, maybe I do. Rogue's kit. Away!
Rogue's kit usually has a mirror.
This one apparently doesn't. It's because it had the pittance, probably, that it doesn't have a... Oh, no, it does have a mirror! Yes, there is a mirror!
Power shield.
No, I've got a mirror. I pull it out.
Did I ever get my rope back?
I totally look into the mirror. And then squeal in excitement over the awesome color of my eyes.
Can I tie up the sheep girl and just, like, throw her over my shoulder?
Yes, you can. Okay. Once you've finished riding her for the first couple times in the day, she is so exhausted as to be completely helpless.
Bessie, that's mean. Also, look!
Green hair, I'm teaching her to have eyes. Better orgasms.
Oh.
Feels good, right?
You should stop eating me.
I'm not eating you. I'm fucking
Why?
You. There's a difference.
Why?
Snoo.
Cause bad things.
Like what?
Kind of bad things.
She like squirms and tries. You get the feeling she's trying to point at something, but her arms are tied.
Why'd you tie her up?
Use your words.
Bad sheep. Bad sheep.
I don't know, it tastes pretty good to me.
No. In you, bad sheep. Bad sheep.
Meh.
No, moo. Moo.
She's like a chest burster suddenly pours out.
Now that she mentions it, Bessie, despite having basically drained yourself of the several cream pies, your belly is actually still kind of plump. Much it's more normal. So than it was before.
Totally normal. This is a regular thing that happens to cowgirls.
That's making babies. Yeah. You give her a spoonful of ice cream just to be like, enjoy. She's tied up and can't eat. Ice cream.
She eats it out of your little spoon, but gives you these like big pleading eyes. Like, help.
Later, she's stronger than me.
My turn.
Oh, you need some sheep cock.
My turn.
Can we untie her?
I'll just like put her on the ground in front of Alice.
Dallas will untie her.
She's not gonna let you fuck her then.
She leaps up and gives Dallas a huge hug. Thank you. And then like runs past her out into the snow.
Oh.
Dallas blinks.
Bessie, you mean.
Dallas blinks.
No, I'm moves, Bessie.
And then just kind of. Like, whatever.
Like, whatever.
She just doesn't care. Moo.
I will wander on after the sheep to see where she went.
Hey. Also, MooHiMe. You know, now that the sheep's mentioned something about sheep inside of people and has pointed out that, Bessie's looking a little bit plumper than usual. You feel a slight tightness in your belly, too. Maybe you should lay off the food for a little bit.
But not some
ice pregnancy. Cream!
Yeah, it's too much ice cream. So, Cinnamon, you go after Horhazia.
Horhazia.
And find her, about 3 feet up the side of the mountain. Trying to scramble up and just, like, slipping down with exhaustion every time.
Where are you going?
Gotta get away. Gotta get away. No more bad
Why?
Sheep. They're eating me.
I don't know. What do you mean?
Gina cut out. Your friends, like, they keep this. She just flails her arms helplessly, then indicates her enormous erection, then back towards Bessie and Dallas and MooHiMe.
Called sex.
No, not sex. Eating! Worse than the ogre.
Why do you say you're eating?
You don't make any sense.
Yeah.
It's just all of my spirit energy. She's like,
spirit was a.
This is part of me. And she like grabs her huge nuts and just hefts them up. I need all of this. She's part of me.
You druid? A jizz druid?
This is, I don't understand. Do you want to keep the cum inside you?
Yes, yes, yes.
Why?
Because it makes me stronger.
What?
I don't know.
You have heard of certain types of magic that rely upon seed to function.
Ah, she's a geozomancer.
Usually this is the type of magic that involves a witch lying with a man and taking his seed into her, but maybe the Graham girl's figured out a way to get it all herself. Either way, any sort of sexual contact seems to completely drain her physically. That much you've noticed for sure.
I will look at the others and be like, no more sexing the big awesome penis.
No.
I didn't even get a turn.
Neither did I. I know. She like pout and look away.
And suddenly Hazy is just like all teary eyed. I'm sorry. I didn't want to hurt your feelings. So I tried to hide it, but it felt really good.
Aww. Yeah, that's why you should do it as much as possible.
But then I'll never be strong enough to fight the hobgoblins and the ogres and all of them.
We can fight them for you.
But I don't want people to fight for me. I want to be strong too.
Then lift weights or something. And I'll suck your dick while you do it.
She gives you this... this sort of disbelieving look. but I'm just a little thing. I can't fight like you.
Be sneaky. I'm sneaky.
I thumbs up.
I guess it's your call, but I seem you to could... really like your dick, so I can't guarantee that you won't wake up with me on it.
That's mean. No.
What if we just, like, licked your balls for a couple of hours without letting you get off? Would that give you more spirit energy?
Maybe?
I will hand her the rope and tell her to tie me up.
She, like, looks between you and the rope, and the rope again. Oh, okay.
If that's the only way you can be strong, we'll make you as strong as possible.
By God, if we build it, they won't come.
Playtime?
Alright, Bessie, you get tied up and put on your back. And a very uncertain Hazia drops her skirt and sits on your face.
Alright.
Would any other cow care to...
I'll just go ahead and add the point of Moo before you can tell me to.
Smart call.
I know where this is going.
Would anyone else like to join in helping Hazia achieve spiritual nirvana through sucking her giant tanuki balls?
Well, it's to help a friend.
You Pumpkin's been in like one place.
So that you don't jump people. That shit. Super hot. I couldn't stop myself. Also, I think I'm pregnant.
I'll help.
Alright, so we have two moos on the balls. Anyone else like to hop on?
Nah, I'm gonna go indulge in being free range as fuck and explore the side of the mountain a bit without going too far because blizzards.
Alright. Let's see. Poor Hazy here is going to need to make a fortitude save. That's her best save, though.
She got point blank shot.
Alright. After about 2 hours of balls licking, Hazia is back up to her, like, pumpkin-sized nuts.
Oof.
And they show no sign of stopping. It's whatever magic she has enchanted herself with is immensely potent, of that you are sure. Unfortunately, Cinnamon, why don't you roll me a will save? Because there is an intense masculine aroma just radiating off of this that's making it really hard to keep control of yourself.
Uh-oh. Is this minus Moo?
I think minus Moo, yeah.
Then it's just a flat d20 now.
Okay.
Fucking A.
Good job.
You guys gotta tie yourselves up. We all have to be tied up.
No!
The mind is a fortress.
Just a writhing tongue pile waiting for the balls.
Hazia's muscles have turned completely to jello by the time you're done with her. And she flops onto her side, cross-eyed, and leaking a mighty stream of free. But
I will.
Has not
come. I will pick her up, put her in my lap, and I will cradle her, and moo softly, and I will nurture her and let her suckle.
Excellent. Her strength returns surprisingly quickly with a little bit of nurturing.
Hooray!
Yay!
However, Bessie is still tied up on the ground, and
that's probably for our best of us.
Yeah, that's right. Unfortunately, a mighty stream of free had landed on Bessie's face, and is currently driving her absolutely insane.
Sounds fine.
Bessie, why don't you roll me a strength check to try and break your bonds?
Oh no!
Hulk! Fuck!
Nope. You are left there for several minutes with a splash of spunk on your face and just sniffing that alluring aroma.
Can't I just, like, roll to my side and then, like, smear
wipe
it off
your face in the dirt? I guess, yeah. Once you get desperate enough.
Or just, like, cow tongue. Just engage the cow tongue.
You survived the torture by spunk.
I did it.
Is there anything interesting on the mountainside?
Well, Pumpkin, let's find out. Why don't you roll me a d20?
Thank God that wasn't just roll a perception. Pretty close should have passed. Fuck.
Alright. You don't find any creatures on the mountainside, but you do find several patches of this nasty green fungus that seems to be growing everywhere. Even in the face of the blizzard, which is threatening to blow you off the side of the mountain, this stuff's sticking around.
It does look like it's coming from anywhere.
Yes. Once you recall what Dallas had said earlier, you quickly find your way down onto the rocky outcropping where there is a small crevasse. It's a very tight fit, but a person could squeeze in there and there's a lot of fungus in there. A lot. It's dark.
Well, I'm careless. Sticky. I'm gonna fucking just go for it. Whatever.
All right. So
I'm a rogue. I know this shit.
Roll me a finesse check to squeeze your busty ass on in there.
Fuck.
All right. So the rest of the party.
Is there a way for me to reroll at
does
all
your,
in the system?
Does your butt get stuck?
Can I call on my characters? Fucking carelessness and try again.
Let's see. Which moo type are you?
Free range cow.
Free range? Yeah. You're being pretty careless. So. Although, actually, you already rolled, so it's a little late.
Oh, okay.
So, no. Rest of the party. Sometime during the balls licking session, you hear a desperate moo from somewhere outside.
Darn it.
Not it.
Yeah, you're definitely not it. You and Pumpkin are somewhat occupied. But MooHiMe, Dallas, and
I'll ask Goblin wife who will give me a push. Hobgoblin wife who is pretty strong, right?
Yeah, she's Hobgoblin. They're tough.
I'll ask if she'll come down and give me a push.
Yeah, she... Once you call up to her, she says she'd like to, but you're 20 feet down and she can't really get to you.
I even left the pittance, and she'll just fucking wiggle.
And yeah, Tlack will, like, turn around and say that, pumpkin stuck down there.
Pumpkin done fell down a well.
I think she needs help.
And
she'll go and get the rope and, like, try and pull Cinnamon or somebody to help.
Ooh, Dallas is strong. Get Dallas! What is it, boy? You hear something, boy?
Dallas, you are approached by a hobgoblin wife with a rope, asking you to go yank Pumpkin out of the crevasse she has gotten her stuff for badass stuck in.
Okay. I will go with the rope and...
Alright. So...
Trot over there.
So first make a climb check to get down there safely.
Alright. Let's see if I can do this. I got a 6.
Damn it.
I fell.
Thunk. Thunk. 6 points of damage as you face plant 20 feet into the...
I forgot she's bad at ropes. Yep.
Pumpkin manages to get real small real fast before about 300 pounds of cow just slams into the dirt. Thunk.
I will forcibly try and milk myself against the ground to make space so I can climb through. Because I am not getting rescued by Dallas anytime soon.
And no, it's okay. So Dallas is on your level now, unless she's unconscious.
She's not. So she gets up, kind of dusts herself off for a second, rubs the snow and dirt off her nose, because you didn't see that. That didn't happen. And makes a strength check to shove her fat ass through.
Alright.
I've been fooled.
This is Sparta. Thump. And Pumpkin goes flying through this tiny little crevasse that is completely covered in horrible green goop, which is now completely covering you, and you tumble into the cavern proper.
I'm gonna follow her. I'm gonna wiggle through.
Okay, make a...
Because I'm not getting up.
Make a finesse check.
Damn it.
I think with disadvantage because you are wearing, like, metal heavy armor.
No, her armor is,
Aren't you wearing scale armor?
She is wearing... Where is it?
So I was pretty sure you took a suit from the...
She's wearing studded leather because she couldn't fit into the other one.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Then, yeah, you're just a normal check, then.
Just all right, squished
dex,
up
right?
Bridges.
Yeah, dex.
14.
Alright. It is a very tight fit, but luckily you have been milked recently, so... Actually, wait, no, you're still full of ogre spunk. You have a giant fat belly.
I took a bath.
Yeah, you took a bath, then you got to, Ramcock suppository, whatever. There's been a lot of overflow into that poor belly of yours. So it's a real tight squeeze. And you're pretty sure you feel a waterfall just sploosh down your thighs by the time you're done. But you manage to pop through the other side as well.
Awesome. With my belly significantly smaller, I assume.
Yes, significantly smaller. But no less pregnant.
That's fine.
You've taken away the swimming pool. What have you done?
Let's see, I'm gonna grab...
Make a wiggle check.
Gonna grab Shou, and I'm gonna grab Pumpkin. Put you over there.
Spumpkin.
Spumpkin.
Okay, where the hell are we? Screen.
And the two of you find yourselves not in a cavern for very long.
What?
Once you wipe the green goop off of your bodies a little bit, enough to actually clear your eyes. You look around and see that, these walls are very straight and very carved, and the floor has tiles on it. And turning around, you see that there is a large crack in the wall
like some sort of impact shattered it, leading to the crevasse. Ooh. You're in some kind of structure.
Ooh.
A structure that is overgrown with horrible green moss.
Hmm.
Horrible or awesome?
Pretty horrible smelling.
Oh, smelling. Mm.
And it's sticky and dank and nasty.
Mm-hmm. I look for traps, like in the nearby place. I was like, stone walls! Traps, I must find traps.
You find traps? Place. No, really, you do.
Ooh.
All around you, you see, of course, the fungus clinging to the walls, but also several mushroom-like spores near the doors to the north and west. You think if you get close to them, they might rupture and spew you with something. Better be very careful.
Or I could just try and pop them safely and then go through. Yeah. Let's see, yeah. Does the rogue kit come with a 10-foot pole as well, just to really up the I was prepared for this shit measure? It doesn't. I'm going to have to just shoot them all gradually. How many arrows did I bring?
Alright, let me see if I can find a shroom token here.
Oh, I've got 43 now. I forgot we looted those hobgoblins. Yay! Alright. I tell Dallas that the mushrooms are bad. Don't go near.
Okay.
I wish I was.
Dallas! There. Dallas doesn't say anything, but Dallas's player says Savin should look at Discord real quick.
Okay. Aw, yeah.
Oh shit, is it done?
It is.
Aw, we can't see it.
Aw, yeah.
Is that working the butt slot, Amanda?
Mm-hmm. It's saved in a JPEG and it's really shit, despite the fact that I saved it as a PNG. I did, but it loaded to Imgur as a JPEG and I can't get it to not do that because it's dumb.
It's dumb.
That is an awesome picture. Well fucking done.
Thoroughly, thoroughly good shit.
I'm pleased.
You even have the blue nail polish.
I did even have the blue nail polish.
Such butt slut Manda to 100,000%.
Yep.
Okay. Is there a breeze coming from anywhere? So we could possibly go get our friends, or are you going to just call to them like, come through the tomb?
Let's see. Is there a breeze coming through anywhere? You think there might be one coming from the northern passage, but it's a good ways off. The way you came in is definitely the shorter way back to the party.
I'm gonna hold my nose, put my face up to the crevasse, and then shout out, Moo! It means adventure.
Please tell me you get a point of move for that.
No, I'm just speaking Calgo.
It's not an actual language. This is established.
Yes,
it is established as a language. What? You can learn it as a language.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
I thought it was the other way around.
No, even Becky knows how to speak Calgo.
I thought that was a joke.
No, she has learned fluent Calgo.
They don't have a language because they're mentally... nothing.
Well, that's the thing. It's not a language. It's the ability to communicate complex ideas to cowgirls.
Yeah.
It's like sign language or, I don't know, cards.
Yeah, it's obviously codes, but no one else but the cowgirls know that I have just adventure is over.
It's like playing charades.
That language is squashed.
Cowgirl is like playing charades with a lot of mooing and high.
Yes.
Nope.
Yep.
Nope.
Yeah, you get the moon adventure.
Yes, Hedrah.
Did you compare talking and communicating ideas to, like, animal intelligent creatures like cowgirls in 7D to fucking sign language?
Look, it's the best I could come up with on short notice. It's a very bad comparison.
Okay, it's good to know that you see people who can't communicate verbally and have to do with their hands are as smart as fucking animals, are no higher standing the fucking animals. You're such a good person, Saban.
No one has ever argued otherwise.
Moo. Oh, yeah, now that I got my token, I should put that point on. Punch two. It's not too bad. I think Dallas's one needs to gain some more, which is terrifying, because she already had a bunch.
I need to gain two.
Woo! You are beyond halfway moving. Does anyone hear the call to adventure?
Oh, the party does, although there's some residual balls lust going on in there.
I think they need help.
I think they need fucked.
Should we go and help them? We should go and help them.
Yes.
If I untie you, are you guys going to go and tackle the goat sheep?
Oh shit, I didn't mean to do that. Shou accidentally leaves the roll 20.
No.
Goodbye, Shou. We'll miss you.
Shou 20.
Yep.
Shou 20, smoke it up.
Smoke it up.
Huh? You're lucky.
So, party. You hear the call to adventure from your fellow cows. What do?
I will begin. I will let sheep girl. She a sheep girl. Or she a goat.
She is a ram girl.
Ram girl. I will let her. I will lay her down, and then I will go and I will grab Bessie, and we'll start dragging her towards the entrance.
Move. Let's go.
It's like when you have to hit the booby horn. Booby.
Reaha, you take keep an eye on. What's her name?
I'll say it, buddy. But isn't she currently stuffed to the brim with power?
It's Tamika, the hobgoblin, and Reaha will stay behind, but. Hazia will offer to come with if you want. She's also one of the only people who can climb with the shit here, so.
That's a very good point.
Even stuffed as she is all of a sudden.
Okay.
Alright, so, would everyone who's coming down give me a athletics check with advantage? Because you now have a ram girl who can guide you down. Good job, good job.
14.
Okay, that's only the first one. Okay.
Oh god, 8? MooHiMe is the most.
She is the most, it's true. And Bessie?
Huh, what save?
Athletics check to climb down to join the party.
Oh, I thought I was still slurping cum. I mean, balls. I'm in cum balls.
No, you stopped doing that ages ago.
I never stopped doing that.
It just having like one of those sort of like the, your train spottering right now with cum.
So, MooHiMe almost falls, but luckily she gets a pair of ram horns up the butt, which stabilize her just enough so she can get her footing back. And before long, the rest of the party joins.
Hi. And I tell them, don't touch the mushrooms. They're bad. They'll gas you.
Okay.
So, don't forget to update your moves now that you have tokens.
Yes, everyone update your
tokens.
I'm still on the world map.
Oh, that's
I'm
right.
Forever on the world map this session. That's... I haven't seen my token all game.
Everyone is now together on this map.
Well, I mean, this is pretty much any map we've had.
How do we stay away from them? Don't we have to go through the doors?
We have to pop them, and then we can go by. And I'm going to pull out my bow. Nope, I pull out my bow, and I'm going to lance through the first of the spore cloud.
Alrighty.
What are the spores doing?
I tell everyone to, like, get a decent, like, get up against the walls because that's probably still in range to get spoofed.
But what do the spores do?
Probably terrible things. I don't know. I don't know nature stuff. Maybe I do. Do I know nature stuff? Let's find out.
I know nature stuff.
Nope. I don't know. They're bad.
I'm gonna go stab a mushroom.
No.
Alright.
I have a sword! Stab!
Excellent. Roll damage.
I don't know nature stuff.
I think it's just 1d8 plus 1.
Stop choking your sneezes. I will beat your butt until it's concave, otherwise.
Oh man, it took me so long to train Sonara out of that habit.
I'm sorry. Also, Bessie rolled an 81. So I'd many, like to point out.
So many
a one, you've got a 1 and a 1d81.
Amazing.
I think your sword breaks off into you.
Yeah. Your sword just teleports up your own ass and you die. No. Try again.
That's incredible.
Oh, that roll doesn't count? Alright.
If you roll a 1 again, it counts.
3!
Fucking barely.
Amazing.
MooHiMe, you probably wanted to back up against the wall. Happen because I have no doubt that you're stood in the cloud of stupid right now.
I'll let you retroactively move X.
Because it said before she botched, I was like, everyone should probably back up.
I got a shield, I'll be fine.
Alright.
Shields protect you from things.
So, MooHiMe, Bessie, and Hazy all need to make reflex saves as this huge fungal mushroom explodes and shoots out razor sharp spores everywhere.
It's fine. It's... I got a shield.
Bessie dances daintily through them.
No, I just lifted up my shield. It's fine.
Apparently, Hazier has got the fucking happy feet.
Yep, she like, trips
and falls. Oh, Jesus, what's with your rolls? All of you got 20 plus.
Yeah, we're good.
Yeah.
Get on our level, scrub.
Yeah, you're good. Unfortunately, there is now a hideous green cloud wafting through the air. If I can find something.
Everyone blow at it.
Yeah, basically.
Just breathe really heavily. This will help, I promise.
Oh, that's lame.
It's got a white background. Who shit does that?
I need to take a massive piss. Let me know if I'm dead when I'm back.
Okay.
He's dead when he's back, right, guys?
Oh, yeah, no matter what.
Okay, great.
Why would you put white backgrounds on things in Roll 20?
Covering a face. I was going to say, I'll help you find one, but I can't look up tokens on the player.
Oh, here we go. This will do. And you can have...
Keyword poof. Rudy.
That's it. Yeah, there we go. There's now a hideous green cloud wafting through the air. But hey, that one mushroom's gone.
I'm like looking for shit that I can use to make a face mask. I don't have anything that can be used as a face mask. Okay, cool.
I have a mirror. I didn't know that.
Yeah, which one do you have?
I have the bard one.
Yeah, it's because bards are basically cooler rogues.
You know what I love about the fact that I also have in my bard kit?
Face paint.
No, a journal, an ink pen, and ink.
Yeah, like you'll ever use that shit. I like to draw cows.
MooHiMe, you feel Hazia pulling on your shoulder, saying, maybe we should get away from that?
Bessie's hotboxing right now.
Yeah, oh yeah. She just got
fine.
The full
I've got
load
a shield
in the face.
It will protect me.
And she just uses it as a giant fucking bong.
It's for some reason you hear reggae music playing from the bard.
Yes. I'm gonna pull out my bedroll.
Alright.
And I'm gonna flop it at the thing.
Did I die?
No, but you are standing in a green cloud. Would you like to do anything in the
I would like to breathe it in.
Okay.
What does it smell like?
It smells like rotten fish. Oh, also gross. Make a fortitude save.
Gross.
Alright, you manage to resist vomiting immediately upon smelling the rotten fish smell. But you feel a burning in your throat as you just get a face full of this shit and sniff it.
Hey guys, Bessie farted.
The rest of you...
That's actually pretty funny.
While Bessie is choking on green shit, you watch in shock as her hair changes colors to a vibrant, verdant green. Her eyes become monocolored.
We match!
And, Bessie, roll me a d6.
Oh boy! I roll the best d6s, everyone knows that.
Jesus!
Alright. Flowers erupt all throughout your hair. Except they're not very pretty flowers in this case. They're these sort of fungal flowers made up of a coarse, almost spongy substance.
Fungi sort don't of have leaks. Flowers.
Yeah, they don't, but yet your hair does. Even your horns, actually, and as you reach up, you can feel that they've become much softer than before. Almost porous feeling. And several of these little buds bloom up through them.
Hey, guys.
Oh, no, I went through the goo.
Why do they invite me to the parties? Because I'm a fungi.
I don't get it. What's a fun guy?
This is the guy who's fun. I'm fun.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna walk out of this cloud now.
Alright.
That stinks. But I look cool.
Worth it!
We match.
Yeah, from this safer distance, I'm gonna shoot the next one that's over there from, like, with my bow instead.
I'm going to fist bump Dallas.
For matching?
Fist bump.
What does my hair smell like?
Probably
your
lots
hair
of
smells
farts.
Like rotten fish.
My hair smells like farts. Wait, did you say fish?
Yes, rotten fish.
I need to shave my head.
Does my hair smell like fish?
No, it does not.
The fuck? Uh-huh. Fuck this gay earth. It's fucking terrible. You're all terrible.
Do we have any
everyone but myself for this.
Yeah, of course. This is
the person who hot boxed the fucking cloud.
Yeah, does the bedroll thing work?
Yeah, eventually you can, like, waft the cloud away from you.
Sweet. I will help.
Nope.
With my awesome cloak, I will continue with wafty motions, and we're gonna walk this thing away from us.
Alright.
So while Dallas is doing this, she looks at you guys. She's like, you know what would be really awesome? If we had light. And four little orbs of light pop up over her head.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Do you know what else would be awesome? Diamonds, jewels, and even more.
I want a hot pocket.
I want a big dick.
Hazy just immediately starts shaking.
Trembling.
Okay.
So, she unknowingly just cast dancing lights.
Sweet.
Excellent.
Wow.
Oh, charisma casters. Can I just start using my sword to shave my head?
Yes.
Okay.
So, may I have a couple of torches?
You may. Let me hop over to Mr. Dynamic Lighting Layer.
Hi.
Guys, this isn't working out. We should abort this quest and go home. This quest is dumb.
You hit the... I said don't touch the thing!
There you go.
Yeah, but what do you know?
Thank you.
I know, the traps are... I approve the traps are bad.
One of them kind of totters over this way. And the other one totters over this way. And then they just kind of float there.
Let's see. Do your dancing lights have any physical presence, or are they just, like, raw magical light?
They are little orbs of light.
Alright, cool. They waft around without any problem.
Mm-hmm.
Pumpkin's gonna take a deep old breath and go, "Hi!"
Your voice echoes throughout the caverns and chambers within.
She's gonna listen and then try and figure out exactly how far it takes for shit to come echoing back. It's dungeoneering as fuck, yo.
Yeah, make a, let's see, what skill is that?
Fucking stanky fish hair. God damn it, Savin. Dead to me.
Stand, fucking hotbox the cloud, why don't you? Goddamn fault.
Roll nature. Do you know what hotboxing is? You try, well, look, that cloud ain't going anywhere and we're in space. You were hotboxing that cloud for a little while.
I thought, I didn't think I was allowed to move yet. I assumed it was, like, everyone was doing their thing.
You said you were just going to sit there and sniff it.
I'm going to sit there, take a deep breath, and then go, I wonder what it smells like.
I was going to sniff it.
Yeah, well, you did.
What kind of fucking transformation have you ever been
in a science class where they say, don't just sniff shit, waft it towards you?
This isn't real life.
It's just fantasy.
Anyway,
it's supposed to be just fantasy, not get TF'd into a horrible shroom person.
Well, see, don't walk too close to that other one that I've already warned you about.
You can't just be a sexy shroom person.
Don't stand near these things, they're dangerous.
Wine. All right, pumpkin roll nature.
Damn it.
You hear mooing in the distance, and then you get distracted by a very pretty tile on the floor.
Damn it. Yeah. I'll, I don't know, dig a knife under it and pick it up.
It breaks.
Oh.
She's gonna look at this thing. She's gonna look at the cloud and be like, this would really help if we had a fan.
And
a fan, like, appears in her hands, and she squeals in delight as she uses prestidigitation to make a fan. And then starts wafting it at them much faster than her bedroll.
What? Are you sure that it also wouldn't be a really good idea to have lots of money?
Money would be nice.
What if we had 100 more ramcocks?
No. You'd just
that's
be...
That's a lot.
That's too much.
I don't need all of them. I can share. Just as long as there's more than one, I can share.
She's gonna make a... as Bessie talks about the ramcocks, prestidigitation again, as a small approximation... of Hazy's dick appears.
I'll put that
and
in
is given
vagina,
over to
so.
Bessie's.
As soon as I finish shaving my head of this gross ass shit.
It takes you a couple minutes, but eventually.
Since
you
my
are
horns
out.
Are just like sponges now, I can just cut those off too, right?
That Jeez. Sounds like it's gonna hurt. Your horns Why? Also don't smell bad, but.
Oh, okay. Well,
you could probably wash that smell off, but you know.
I'll hand Pumpkin, like, the fans that I make, and then just be delighted in the fact that more of them keep...
Yay!
So many.
Eventually, you push them all the way to a corner that twists around.
All of my lights have to be within a certain range of me. So.
What would the rest of the party like to do? Well,
I'm
they
following.
Are fanning away toxic clouds.
I'm following.
Alright. Hazy will follow as well. Bessie, you've been left behind. Would you like to follow?
Yes, I would.
Can I see that it's like pushing up against a wall, so there's probably something to the left?
Yes.
I hold my breath, shut my eyes, pinch my nose, and run right through and around.
Alright, make a constitution check.
Shit. But I mean a 4, yeah? Or just literally the con score?
Constitution check. Also a reflex save.
Fuck.
Alright, so you get around through the cloud, but the stuff clings to your skin and just starts burning really badly. You have to open your eyes and start wiping the stuff off before it can get too bad, but just as you pop out the other side of the cloud, you realize that you're basically next to another mushroom, which immediately goes and then spores. With a wet sort of farting sound, it explodes.
Let's have a look here. 15 feet. That looks further away from gas and spores. I'm going to run right through.
Alright, well, yeah, alright. So you reflex save, you leap, like, against the wall, dodge the poison spray, and start running. So at this point, I'd like everyone to roll initiative.
Shit.
Because Pumpkin here just found this really... I think I just took Bessie off.
Why? Why do you do this to me? Okay, it's fine.
Fine. So, as you're dodging away from this cloud, you see that there's a very large puddle of goop just sitting on the floor here. A goop that, when you explode the spores, starts jiggling and bouncing around as all these razors plummet into it. And then it starts moving.
I'd like to point out that Pumpkin and I both got 18.02, and our initiative bonuses are the exact same.
Yeah, that's what the decimal is.
Yeah.
So we actually have to do a tiebreaker, and then one of us gets 0.01.
Yep.
Bring it up. Oh.
I think you're going before me.
I could have gotten a 1. Or 2.
Help, I'm taking all this LSD.
Need to get you some sweet, sweet jet.
Wrong campaign setting.
Never the wrong
campaign. Yeah, I gotta get sweet, sweet sting. Nope, wrong one again.
Sweet, sweet amphetamines.
Turbine? No. No. What? Wait, what is the jet of this place? Or does it need inventing? Backy inventing.
I'm pretty sure
some sweet, sweet dragon testosterone.
I'm pretty sure at this point the jet is just literal cocaine.
Oh, okay.
Also, MooHiMe, you're up first. You hear an explosion of spores somewhere nearby. That sounds kind of like a wet fart. And then Pumpkin screaming.
That's always... You're making the mushrooms so gross.
They are gross.
I'm going to have to write Sexy Mushroom Girls now, and it's all your fault.
Oh no, whatever will I do?
Oh no, he's writing porn in comparison. Yeah, you had the shroomies.
What the fuck?
Yeah, the mushrooms.
Okay, so I don't think I have one here.
I didn't write that shit.
Almost the whole fucking day. So what the hell was you saying, Satan? I could give shit.
I said, you heard a spore explode somewhere nearby, and then Pumpkin screaming.
It's the moo of alarm.
Is this a wall, or is there like a leaf down?
That is a wall.
Stairs are like that.
It is a wall.
How thick, is it?
Oh, fuck.
You don't know. From where you're standing?
MooHiMe smash?
Well, I could.
Be the mooest.
I have to.
It does not look like there is much room to avoid the clouds. Fuck you.
Oh, no, that was clever. Fuck you for not liking it.
Yeah, this is right. Good.
I should more alcohol.
Can I tap on the
whoever
wall?
Whoever made that pun sounds like a real fun one. Guy.
Yes, you can tap on the wall. Make an intelligence check.
Also, good evening.
Hi, Lily.
Good morning.
I hope you're ready for the evening of Infinite Overwatch, because Anna's out.
Oh, boy.
Hey. Oh, MooHiMe, you figure the wall's just about 2 inches thick, but it is made of stone.
I am the most.
Oh, God.
I will not be stopped by anything because we have friends that need help and we shall overcome even the fierceness.
I think I already overcame.
Even break through the walls that blocks our paths.
I'm going to break through the
greatness.
All right, want to make a make an unarmed attack against the wall? Is that where this is going?
Yeah.
All right, roll your damage. Actually, roll a d20 just to see if you crit, just in case, you know.
Ooh,
so close.
Go high, me.
Go ahead and roll damage.
Indeed. Not yet. If I get one more level, I can actually do that.
Sweet.
I get two weapons fighting. No, not 1d20. That would have been cool, though, to do that time.
It's a lot of punch.
Such fisting. Too deep. Wow.
Wow.
Indeed. So, as a move action, I will activate my martial flexibility, and with that gain power attack on my punch.
Oh boy. Alright. I'm down with it.
Crack, crack, pop.
That's it.
Alright. You give the wall a mighty punch. Boom! And blast your fist straight through it. You can now see Pumpkin.
Hi.
You can't quite fit through the hole, but you can definitely see her. However, if, say, a ram were to go and smash her head on that much weakened wall, you think it might come tumbling down.
I do mention that past side, on the side, that maybe somebody with big horns could smack on the wall as well to help make the hole bigger.
I'm on it. I can do that. Yeah.
Am I blind or where is Dallas?
It's a good question. Where is Dallas?
The hell?
Oh, she's under MooHiMe.
It's Dallas's go. Well,
yep. Right.
Dallas is going to send her light through.
Ooh. Hi.
So that it's hovering over the top of the goop.
So, Pumpkin, this time when you say hi, you hear four voices giggle. Hi, 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 hi. From the goop.
Her response is joy.
Dallas is gonna kick at the, gonna kick at the wall. Don't want to cover the two girls, so I'm gonna set that right there. So Dallas is going to do a kick at the wall.
All right, go ahead and roll damage.
Try and bust a hole in.
Kick at the wall.
Oh shit, you crunch. Crunch goes the wall.
Cool.
Hey, what's it called? Are we going to do a sex here?
Are we like going to do a sex
just here? Punching through the wall?
Yes.
And then just...
just ripping it open?
Then we got...
There's got to be some, like, anime smiles right now with the sparkle.
Dallas just kind of... Dallas looks at the wall that she just, like, destroyed and then just kind of... ears droop a little bit, eyes get wide.
Property damage?
That was...
No.
Badass.
That was my fetish.
That's perfect. We pose JoJo style.
To be continued. All right. Anything else on your turn, Dallas?
No, that's full mouth alchemist.
It's gonna... because she's got the one light right there, and then the other one over there. Well, she'll drop down.
All
right.
Hi.
No.
And she's going to waft at the other thing.
Okay.
Because it needs to go away, because it's in the way.
Boop.
Okay. And then she'll get out of the way of the hole.
Alrighty. Pumpkin, as you say hi to the light, four colorful feminine shapes rise up out of the goop, bouncing and jiggling and giggling, and regard you with big eyes full of wonder.
I bounce and jiggle as well. Okay. Hi, I'm Pumpkin.
Hi. Pumpkin, oh, God. Pumpkin.
What are your names?
The goose giggle, but do not give a name.
It's fucking the correct Hodor.
Yeah.
The correct Hodor.
Hold the door.
Oh, now
once you fuck them in the correct hold the door, then the door opens.
Oh, that's...
Oh, shit. Don't you see, if they are the ones that are the door, doesn't mean we need a key and a key master?
Don't make me go see the new Ghostbusters, please.
Dude, don't do that. Watch that. Do not watch that shit. It's completely fucking retarded.
She will ask if they would like milk. They've probably been down here for super long.
Milk, moo, hi.
Meh.
Yes, they moo at me. I'm moo. So happy.
Oh god, the moo circle jerk.
Meh. And now it's with a quadruple. The quad.
Bessie, you hear several strange voices from the other room.
There's clouds in my way still, though.
There is a giant hole in the wall, though. You could just walk through.
Whoops. Oh, hi.
Hi, moo. Goo?
Hi, moo.
Yeah, we're gonna keep... Wait, do you have dicks?
They all jiggle and start changing their shapes in all sorts of ways.
Am I still in heat, or am I out of heat now that I'm pregnant?
You are super in heat.
I thought I was pregnant.
And?
Oh, okay. Alright, yeah, then I will just tackle the nearest one and start fucking her.
Excellent.
I'm going to solve the puzzle, guys.
Alright, so you're going after Miss Purple here?
Sure.
Alright, go ahead and move on where you want to go.
I don't really see color, so yeah.
Blue.
So make a CMB check to grapple.
You're killing me here, Smalls.
Smalls.
That should be something you're super good at, though.
It's really not.
You tackle the goo.
Sploosh.
Milk! Milk, hi, moo. Cinnamon.
Moo!
We'll hop down.
Oh. Hi!
Hi, 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 hi.
These guys look nice. They look nice, right?
They look like super cute goo girls. Now, so look at dicks.
I want to hug this one.
Alright, make a CMB check.
Big squishy hugs. Oh.
She is super wiggly and squishy and wet.
CMB, that's, how do you figure that out?
It's, strength. Your strength and BAB, so. For you, just your strength bonus.
Let's see. BAB, strength, size, stuff like that.
So, just a strength check. Alright, you grab her! And get a hug.
I will say hi!
Actually, you pull her in. She giggles and titters and starts rubbing up against you.
Woo!
Speaking of which, the green goo girl will slither on up and just coil around your other side and start rubbing up against your back.
Hi.
Moo, 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 moo.
You can become one of them.
How's a 16 versus your touch AC, Kina?
My touch AC?
Yes.
That's just your dex, right?
Yep.
That'll definitely hit. I can't stop that.
You take 5 points of psychic damage as her body just smears all over you and you start feeling tingly and lusty and weird all over.
No.
And she's going to just hop on you as well.
No.
The purple goo under Bessie will do much the same thing. Just giggling and grinding all over you. So 15 versus touch for 5 psychic damage as she exploits your lusty status and will happily start smearing you in her aphrodisiac body.
Fry squint.
Then? You just took 5 psychic damage from a goo girl rubbing her aphrodisiac body all over you.
Why did I take damage from that?
Because it is slowly but surely incapacitating you. And eventually it's going to cause you to slump unconscious, and then the goo girl's going to just, you know, suck you dry.
Oh.
However, Bessie, suddenly that horrible fishy smell you were experiencing, completely gone. Everything smells amazing. Everything tastes amazing. It feels amazing.
Okay, so I'm just on drugs now, is what you're telling me.
Yeah, you're super fucking high. You and Cinnamon are going on the trip.
Yay!
I've basically gone to Canada or Colorado.
Yep. So
just all the drugs.
Hazia.
Or Amsterdam.
Yes. Hazia head bashes the wall open a little bit wider. Stampedes in. Looks around and says, "They're adorable! Adorable!" And she squeals. The goo that Cinnamon hugged originally, bloop, will do 3 more psychic damage to her as it just, like, slips a tentacle right into your cooter. Bloop.
Ah, hi!
Hi! The other goos all go, hi! And the last goo next to Bessie will do much the same thing. for 5 more psychic damage as she just piles on and starts vacuuming your tits. Slurp, slurp, slurp.
Wow.
MooHiMe, there are goos all up on your party members.
Okay. Are they just sexing about, or...?
They seem to be, though your companions are also... They look a little out of it, all of a sudden. Like they're maybe a little bit drugged
Cinnamon,
up.
Cinnamon is high as fuck.
Yup. Oh, are you unconscious? Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Cool.
3.
No.
Alright, so yeah, Cinnamon has just collapsed on the ground, and a goo girl is, like, stuck on her tits, and the other is just crawling inside of her bodily.
Tripping balls.
And being infested by a goo girl.
And getting, you know, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. So yeah, that's happening. Bessie's still up, though.
I'm sure it's fine.
Yeah.
Is she?
Well, she's standing.
Come on. How much damage has she taken?
Finn?
I took 5, didn't I?
Yeah, I believe you took 5 and...
Oh, well, there was more?
3. Yeah, you took 5 and 3.
Alright, I have 5 hit points.
Yeah, you're fine.
It's plenty.
Okay, I don't really know what to do here.
I mean, they're literally having a great time.
I will confirm, seems Cinnamon so. Is having a great time.
I guess I got you. They're probably fine. Oh, they're having their own adventure right now. They're on a fucking journey.
A vision quest, if you will.
Yes.
Bagging mad peyote, bros.
These are clearly salvia goos.
So, MooHiMe, would you like to do anything, or leave your companions to whatever these goos want to do with them?
Well, there's a lot of milk to get out of Bessie and Cinnamon. Because
Cinnamon has not been milked for like 3 days.
Oh, you poor thing.
Poor thing.
Bessie.
Alright.
What am I doing? I heard my name. I remembered it this time. Sorry, I'm getting increasingly drunk, by the way.
It's fine.
What did you choose, by the way, for your drink of choice?
151.
Okay.
It's gonna be a night.
Whoa!
It's gonna be a night.
Yeah. What am I doing, Hedrah?
Something.
Is Hedrah also as drunk as me?
When? I have been drinking a little bit more for quite a longer time.
Yeah, but you have more tolerance. I have to play catch up.
That is true, but there's a limit to that. I'm down on my 11th bottle of vodka, so screw you, okay?
Alright. Bessie, when was the last time you got milked, is the question.
A very long time, and by that I mean last session.
So it's been a couple days, man.
I'm pretty sure I like force-fed the shopkeep 16 liters of milk or something like that. I know all of my milk got harvested.
That'd be fine.
Okay, so you produce like 16 liters a day?
Yeah.
So 2 days, not milk, but 32?
I don't think, like, I think if nothing else, Bessie would have shoved her tits in another party member's mouth. Well before it became uncomfortable.
Nine moon in a session? Yeah, that sounds about appropriate.
So, 32 liters and then 3. It's like 94. Oh wait, Kinathis, how many liters do your character produce a day?
How much is it? It's 10 at base, right?
Plus con.
Plus 2 per each con.
Let's see, yeah. 10 plus 2 per con.
I'm currently pregnant, so I don't know if that helps at all. That makes more...
Yep, that'll add another 2 liters.
Okay, then 16 total.
Excellent.
So, 16, 32, 48.
There's an incredible amount 80. Of milk on the offer here.
Yeah, that's 80 liters, which is like...
It's pretty reasonable.
I think it's only something gallons. 80 liters.
I don't know if I'm imagining things, but I swear those mushrooms are moving.
20 gallons.
21.1 gallons.
I'm not the only one who imagines it. Did those mushrooms just move? Okay, whatever. Mm-hmm.
Now Zaven's just fucking with them.
Okay.
No, they're don't you see? They're gypsy shrooms.
Okay. Alright, so anyway, what are you going to do, Moo?
These shrooms, they can do that board shuffle thingy there with the thing under the cups, remember?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Alright, so MooHiMe, are you going to do anything to help out here, or are you content to let the goose harvest a lot of milk?
They can harvest the milk. It would be nice for them.
Alright.
Yeah, have a fucking party.
Dallas, what do?
Dallas is gonna see her friends getting
all the fun
stoned, but she doesn't quite know what that is. They just kind of go slack jawed and dazed.
They're having a real good fuck. Also,
she's gonna bounce forward and start singing, and she's gonna bounce over here, and she's gonna bounce over to here, and. As she fascinates, she is using her bard ability to do her performance to fascinate the goose.
Okay.
Basically, they'll be fascinated unless somebody tries to attack them. It's basically a distraction. I have to be able to see them. They have to be within 90 feet. They have to be capable of paying attention to me. So,
don't think.
But as I was about to say, but she hasn't been milked in 3 or 4 days. She has giant tits. She also has cum just dripping out of her because she had sex with the ogre. And she just flounced.
It has been like 4 days at this point. I think between your belly getting squished and that, you're probably dry of ogre spunk.
No, you said that she squished through that hole and there was a gush of fluid and she hasn't cleaned up.
Oh, okay, fair enough. You still have it on you, it's just not in you anymore.
Yeah, but it's just like everywhere and she just flounced past them and started singing.
All right. In that case, let's see, where did you go exactly? Was it along this path?
She went this way, and then this way.
Opportunity attacks!
Pretty
Are you
much.
Gonna do, like, the fucking All right. choir song?
So...
Kind of what she's doing, yeah.
Oh!
So...
Party's dead. We're all dead.
Dallas, does a 12 hit your touch AC?
No.
Okay. But then you take 3 crits, so 10 and then 8.
Okay.
So you get about here.
I was actually gonna ask, is the one that's climbing inside Cinnamon capable of trying to hit me?
You know what? That's a fair point. That is
Cinnamon.
I mean, technically a goo doesn't have like any sort of facing, so it could just hit you with its ass, but you know what? Alright, I'll make a random check to see which one that was, and we'll decide if it's relevant or not. It is not relevant.
Not relevant. Okay.
So you get about there, and then a couple of goos just leap off of Bessie and Cinnamon. Bloop. Bloop. And just drag you to the ground. And, yeah, just get right up in your grill. And one of them immediately dives into your cunt and just starts drilling inside.
That's fine. I also go completely dazed.
All right, good job, Dallas. Productive turn.
Productive turn. Tried to help. Kinda succeeded.
I'm gonna just look at this mess and be like...
She tried to help.
She'll just fucking pop some shrooms and decide that she'll go around this mess. She'll just spend her turn shooting at these things so they burst.
Okay, roll damage.
Okay.
Just FYI. No, that's fine.
I think they'll be cool. They're not in get-owned range, are they?
Are you sure?
Are they in get-owned range?
They're in the blast radius for the needle spores.
Ah, damn it, I might end up real killing them.
It's a 20-foot radius.
It's oh, a 20, I am.
Yeah.
I'm not in range of the other... Oh, I am. I'm in range of both of them.
Yeah, alright, fine. Instead, I will
There's one over here, Pumpkin.
Yeah, what I'm gonna do is, instead of just even fucking bother popping it, I'm just gonna walk in between them and get to here on the... Be like, that'll be fine. I'm gonna walk between them.
Let me see these squares. Okay, stop.
Stop. Hammer time.
Uh-oh. Make a reflex save.
Oh, dicks.
Okay. Pop.
Can't touch this. Da, 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 da. Can't touch this.
Oh no!
You take 4 points of piercing damage as several needles bury into your skin.
Ow.
Oh. Make a fortitude save, please.
Oh. I hope I don't get fungusy.
Too late, you're gonna smell
like
fish.
Might get fungusy.
But I'm so floofy!
You're gonna be floofy with fish.
Don't do this to me! No, I'm floofy.
So the bad news is that the aerial spores and the needle spores do different things. The worst news is that, Pumpkin, your skin starts softening. You can feel it. At first, what? You just think your veins are just standing out black against your skin, but you're becoming translucent. Pumpkin is beginning to transform into a goo girl.
She's evolving.
She's evolving.
Pumpkin's turning into a goo girl.
So you collapse onto your knees and start just shifting and molting. Your mortal coil.
Goo! Oh, no.
Sister! The goos cheer. You feel a intense compulsion in your mind to say sister as well. But you don't know where that's coming from.
It's coming from your butt. Resist it. The butt is evil.
Bessie, things are looking bad for the team.
The butt is evil.
This is the end of our heroes.
We must destroy it.
Well, you have a single goo girl clinging to you right now.
I have a hammer. Back off, bitch.
But we want fun. We just want homes.
Nope.
The Google will smile off. At you.
Back off is achieved.
Boom!
There's the normal damage roll. I don't know how your system works. It's
just same crits. It's normal.
So, 6.
Is a hammer only times 2?
Oh, I think hammer might be times 3, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. So 2, 3, 6, 9.
I wonder if I could hold two of them as a broodmother.
When you have a hammer, all of your problems become theirs. Right. Ain't that the fucking truth? Yeah.
So you smash the goo right in the head. She bounces and jiggles and goes, "Ow! That really hurt."
Yeah.
Why are they computer programmed?
See. I'm
very confused by the compu goos.
Well, more intended to be like a little chorus of goos that all just like finish each other's sentences.
Oh my god, they're the Weasley twins.
Get out, Harry Potter, get out.
Cinnamon. Sure. You can't really do anything, so there is now a goo just crawling up your cunt and infesting your womb. Your belly bloats and bloats, and you watch in just stark horror as the skin stretches out. And
you Are you sure it's stark horror?
Well, stark horror or incredible arousal, you know, whatever.
I would like to point out that I am the broodmare cow.
In that case, this is baller as fuck. You're like double pregnant.
Fucking yeah, man! I'm 2 minutes at once.
This shit's the best. No. All right.
Well, let's see. Looks like Greenie here's got first dibs on Dallas's cunt. So in she goes.
Dallas is pregnant. Would she be able to get in?
Oh yes, yes she will. Well, you have a butt, so in she goes.
Okay.
Where there's a will, there's a way. Into your butt.
Where there's a will, there's a yally hole.
Where there's a whip, there's a way. Shit, now I'm the nerd.
So yeah, I guess technically, Cinnamon, you have a goo in your butt instead of your...
Aww.
You're pregnant now, though.
I don't want it in my butt. I want it in the other one.
Oh, you have a baby in there. That's going to be bad for the baby. Come to think of it. Having aphrodisiac acid goos living in there is probably a bad deal for it.
You're no fun.
I know. I'm the worst. All right. It is the goo on Bessie's turn, so... It's going to jiggle from side to side and say, "Meanie." And then just lunge at you.
She is a meanie.
Does a 12 hit your touch AC? Bessie.
No. Wait, touch AC?
Yes.
It's like you just want to fuck me. Yes, it does.
All right, you take 6 points of psychic damage.
And I'm unconscious. It's been nice knowing you guys.
All right. You flop to the ground, and the purple goose slithers into your cooch. Actually, wait, nope, you're pregnant. Slithers in your butt.
God damn it.
Everybody's pregnant already. Stop
everyone
that, gals.
Saban makes everyone butt. Go figure.
I made you all normal pregnant first. I'd like to point that out.
Okay.
So there's a goo left standing, and then there's Hacia. Bye, nerds.
Hazy is pretty smart right there.
So, yeah, that's Goo. The Goo who's left standing, who does not have anybody to infest, looks around. Oh, wait,
does she trigger the spore thing when she does that?
No, she does not.
Oh, okay.
She does reach the edge of the pool, though, and sort of reaches out towards you. Elongating one of her limbs. Sister.
No, I'm a cow.
Moo.
Moo. Goo.
Hedrah, you still with us?
Moo. Goo.
I think she might have gone for a nap.
Yep, think so. Alright. Boop. Alright, and everybody except Pumpkin is out of it. So, Pumpkin.
We won the fight, guys. Good job.
Good job, guys.
I'm going to really lean against that fucking wall. And go
good
past
job,
it.
Scals.
Really lean against it.
Alright. So, make a reflex save.
Son of a fuck!
Yep.
Alright, I'll give you advantage since you're both A, gooey, and B, kind of...
Apparently don't need it. Don't worry about it. All right, all as well.
Everybody else? Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. Everybody else.
We can't.
You can't.
They're all unconscious.
So you all get pumped full of needles.
Goo cow party go. Fortitude saves all of you. Except Pumpkin.
Oh, no.
Who's getting out of here scot-free?
Except she's a goo.
Well, yeah, she'll be a goo later, but also he can't.
Oh, man! So this means that the goos that are inside us can't infest us anymore because we're goos.
You had babies.
Well, let's...
Ed, can mine be blocked because there's a goo in front of me?
I will give you advantage on your saving throw to...
Aww.
Alright, Cinnamon, you have goo. You are goo.
I wanted to have a goo, not be a goo.
Well, you might get both.
I want both then.
Dallas is fine. And Bessie. Fortitude.
I would like to become an amalgam goo.
Fortitude, you say?
Yeah.
Balls in Bessie's court now, bitches.
Alright, Bessie is not gooed.
I can't be gooed.
Yes, only Cinnamon is afflicted with gooiness, so you're gonna...
I'm immune to goo.
Yeah. Does gooiness make it easier for me to take giant dicks?
Well, I do hear that gooiness is next to godliness.
Okay, I'm fine. Alright, I'm a little bit more, I'm a little bit more okay with this.
Alright, Pumpkin, you can finish your movement now if you have any left.
Let's have a look here. 1, 2. What the fuck is down this way?
That is just a wall.
Shit, okay. I think that's all of my... I don't know, I had like 30 movement. One, two.
Yeah, you can move all the way like here. Yeah. So you see stairs leading up. And light at the end of the tunnel.
Yay?
No.
How do I feel about my halfway?
Well, your flesh is softened and you're all alone. So you are jiggly, milky, not pregnant, at least as far as you know.
Yeah, I have managed to actually avoid anything going in the cooch and the boot.
So, what do? Pumpkin.
I have to do this. I'm gonna go up.
Alright.
Pumpkin. We're like, maybe there's a wizard in this tower and he'll help. That's what happens when you're doing adventures.
Yeah. Alright.
I know about adventures, guys. I'll be back soon.
And that leaves
find a wizard.
And that leaves our three cows to be bad-ended by the goos, who will infest your wombs and use you as their breeding sows forevermore.
Aww.
Bad end.
Bad ends for Cinnamon, Dallas, and Bessie.
What, really?
Ooh. Yeah.
We're the worst party.
Because we are at the end of our time, I'm afraid.
Our party is subpar.
So you mean there's not going to be a part three?
They never really
I
loved
don't
us.
Think so at this point.
Bitches.
The party has been...
Oh my god, where's Reaha?
You guys left her in a cave with a hobgoblin. With no climbing gear or equipment.
This is the darkest Sav&D there's ever been.
It's okay, Pumpkin escaped and Hazy escaped, so I'm sure they'll get back
it's
there
true.
Eventually.
We're gonna...
Pumpkin,
yeah.
Pumpkin, also Hazy, and MooHiMe escaped.
Yes, so...
MooHiMe? Don't you mean MooHiMe?
Well, let's face it, we all call her MooHiMe, but her name is MooHiMe.
I'm sad I can't just bring the goo with me.
Triple bad end.
Bad yep. end.
I blame our party.
So, here's my question for this. Do we have the babies first, and then become Goo Girl breeders?
Yes, they will allow you to have your first set of babies. Although, those babies will likely grow up to be Goo Girl breeding sows themselves.
So, I'm having a war ogre baby.
Yep, that's good.
Let's find out if mine is a boy or a girl.
I'm pretty sure I'm just going to make my fort saves.
Mine's
until
a
I
boy.
Get tired of fucking and then leave.
just tell yourself that, Bessie. As the months turn into years and your womb becomes perpetually used to constant occupation. You're a tough cow. You can handle it.
Yep.
So, thank you everybody for playing Moo&D. I hope you all had fun.
We won. Good job, guys. We won. Mission accomplished.
Well, I mean, I got out of the encounter, and I am, I didn't get pregnant. I think I did okay.
Yeah.
I'm a fluffy extra jiggly cow.
I look forward to finding all of these goo cows and then having them come move in with my giant goo monster in my basement.
Yeah, these cows could all totally show up in 70, so that's something to look forward to.
They could come live in my basement with my pet goo monster.
Fancy.